I step into the day with the dawn ringing in my ears. Oh, well, I tune to my TV show. No better way, I gotta get myself into gear. Let's go. Oh, and I feel good.
Welcome to it, young'uns. Well, young and old, we are all welcome this morning, but on a Monday, you know, on your feel-good kickstart to the week, we do shine a spotlight on our young achievers in our community, and we absolutely love it, showcasing how, if you put your mind to it, anything is possible.
This is living true. Proof, man. This living is true, proof. Living proof right here. Just a few hours ago, I was somewhere overseas. We'll talk about that just a bit, because I'm back here. So excited to be serving you, Mzanzi. And of course, we're talking about these young talents and superstars that we get to celebrate. And first up, we have 12-year-old sprinting sensation, Lamica Adamson. Yes, she is continuing to break national records, and I cannot wait to dive into this discussion and find out what's making her so fast.
She's gonna have to turn to weightlifting to deal with the medals, man. Just yeah. Like, oh, I've got all my medals, clean and jerk. Then we're gonna meet a local film producer, believe it or not, Santi Naidu, and how she is leaving her mark in Hollywood right now. There is something about South Africans, we're the it people in Hollywood at the moment, and for good reason. And she might be one of those driving forces. Cannot wait to connect to her.
If you're a South African, your intentions are like a magic wand. Just put them out there 100%. And it will materialize. And someone that's doing that as well is our entertainer for the morning. And that is the ever so talented singer, actor, dancer, model. The list goes on. We're talking about Chrissy J. De Beer as she performs her latest single, Pieces of Me. And yeah. Guesses on how old she is.
No idea. Yes, today will be humbling, but we love it. It's going to inspire us as well, and hopefully inspire the younger people out there that are watching right this moment. Now, it's Earth Day, a massive day, an opportunity. I remember when this first came around, I felt like, oh, that's a cool marketing notion, and it suddenly turned into the biggest, most wonderful, I think let's call it a movement. Is there produce that you should be thinking in terms of plastic that should be getting rid of its packaging? We've seen a massive leap forward in this space, but is there something that is there on your daily list that you see every day that should be done away with? 0634088863. What needs to be given the boot when it comes to packaging? Let us know. Inspire us. Let's make it practical. Let's make it real this morning. Earth Day is about that, finding practical solutions to saving our planet. And I have a feeling, once again, you might hold the key. So keep those comments coming. You can also drop a note on any of our social media platforms throughout the day if anything grabs your attention, especially if you want to share a little bit of your motivation, your enthusiasm with the young achievers that we're going to be connecting with this morning. That kind of validation really does work. And if your little ones aren't up yet, wake them up, because it's time to be inspired. In fact, we'll all be hopefully a little inspired and definitely informed with those news headlines, and then I'll touch on some of the sporting headlines.
Thank you so much, G-Man. Yes, official duties must commence, and starting with national headlines. Now, Ezemvelo, KwaZulu-Natal Wildlife, says they have started an immediate program to dehorn hundreds of rhinos in the province to stop widespread rhino poaching. Now, this has KZN recorded a high number of rhino poaching cases, with 325 killed in the past year alone. Now, the spokesperson for Ezemvelo KwaZulu-Natal's Wildlife, Musa Mtambo, says poaching in the province has been extremely rife. Now, 109 rhinos have been killed since the beginning of this year. Now, he also says the dehorning process will not have any significant impact on the rhinos. Well, next up in our local headlines, the Minister of Education, Minister Blade Nzimande, has expressed his concern about the bogus institution, Trinity International Bible University, which awards honorary doctorates to SA celebrities. Now, he says this university has not been authorized to offer any qualifications because it is not a registered private higher education institution. Now, Nzimande's spokesperson, Velium Bele, said the education department was considering action against Trinity. Now, this follows social media posts on Saturday showing veteran actor Selo Make Kankube receiving an honorary doctorate from the institution. Well, over to international headlines right now, and at least 58 people on their way to a funeral have died after their overloaded river boat capsized on the Mpoko River in the Central African Republic on Saturday. Now, people who rushed to assist were able to extract 58 lifeless bodies, but at the time of the rescue attempts, did not know how many people had landed in the river. Now, witnesses said the wooden boat was carrying some 300 people, and some standing and others perched on wooden structures when it capsized. Well, our condolences go out to all those affected, but we carry on with the headlines right now. And next up, a race car has veered off track during a motor race in Sri Lanka, killing 7 people. Now, at least 18 others were injured in the accident at the Fox Hill Supercross event in the town of Diatalawa yesterday. Now, among those fatally injured were 4 race officials, as well as spectators, including an 8-year-old girl. Now, the race was organized by the Sri Lankan military, which has an academy in Diatalawa. Now, there were some 100,000 spectators and eyewitness videos which show people rushing towards the scene in the aftermath. Now, the event subsequently was suspended. Now, finally, this morning, we can categorically state that South Africa remains the most affluent country on the African continent. Now, this as a report published by Henley & Partners in partnership with the New World Wealth has confirmed Johannesburg's status as Africa's wealthiest city, with Cape Town closely following in 2nd place. Now, moreover, SA cities and regions dominate the top 10 rankings, with the Cape Winelands at 6th, Durban and surrounding areas at 7th, and the Garden Route at 8th, and Pretoria at 10th. Now, Cairo, Nairobi and Lagos also feature prominently in the rankings, making up the 3rd, 4th and 5th spots. Now, this latest report truly highlights SA's significance when it comes to the presence in Africa's wealth landscape. Well, we'll carry on the headlines right now, and next up we have the latest when it comes to all the spectacles that took place this weekend when it comes to sporting action.
Thank you so much. Well, let's start with some football and a bit of a roundup of the weekend's action in the FA Cup. And Bernardo Silva's late goal propelled Man City into the FA Cup finals with a 1-0 victory over Chelsea. So despite a pretty challenging match, Silva's decisive strike securing the holders' win. Then in our other thrilling semi-final, Man United, they edged past Coventry City on penalties after a dramatic 3-0 draw in extra time. United's perseverance paying off as Rasmus Højlund's penalty sealing their spot in that final against Manchester City. It's going to be one for the ages. Now let's turn for rugby, and definitely not a weekend for the ages. In the latest round of the URC, the Lions shone bright and pretty much alone with a dominant 44-12 bonus point victory over log leaders Leinster, securing their sole triumph for a South African team this weekend. Disappointment looming as the Sharks fell 21-10 to the Glasgow Warriors, who looked very strong on the night. Then the Bulls, uncharacteristically, they suffered a 27-22 defeat at the hands of a very strong Munster side. And the Stormers, they just weren't clinical as we normally see them at home. They were defeated 27-21 by the Ospreys, who certainly found another gear. The Bulls dropping to 4th place now, while the Stormers, they slipped down to 6th. The Lions win keeps them in contention for a quarterfinal spot, believe it or not, while the Sharks hold on to 13th place. And I say that with all due respect for the Lions after their start of the season, but a fantastic turnaround. Now let's turn to tennis. And world number 6, Casper Ruud, he's a clinched victory at the Barcelona Open, defeating Stefanos Tsitsipas 7-5, 6-3 in a commanding performance. So the win marked a sweet revenge for Ruud after his loss to Tsitsipas in the Monte Carlo Masters final last week. Norwegian with 11 career titles, including the Barcelona Open, he secured the biggest trophy of his career, undoubtedly. So despite 3 previous final losses, Ruud's perseverance paid off with his first title of 2024, solidifying his position as definitely a force to be reckoned with on the tour this year. Now, a force to be reckoned with, well, he's a force to dominate all others at the moment. Max Verstappen, he capped off a commanding weekend by clinching victory at the first Chinese Grand Prix in 5 years, so further solidifying his lead in the World Championships as he did it. So after a dominant sprint victory, the 3-time world champion then controlled the race at the Shanghai International Circuit, which looked fantastic, finishing 13.7 seconds ahead of Lando Norris, with Sergio Perez securing 3rd spot on the podium. So Verstappen's near-perfect weekend only marred by Fernando Alonso still causing trouble. His late dash for the fastest lap with his fourth Grand Prix win this season. Verstappen now continuing to assert his dominance on the track. He's going to be tough to beat. Look at that point differential at this stage of the season. But we love to see it, and that's where we're going to leave our sport for now. It's a brand new week. I'm sure maybe a few weather warnings to be taken in, and then we'll get the temperatures in your neck of the woods.
Thank you so much, G-Man. Yes, you have it correct. We're always coming at your service when it involves the weather, of course. And the SA Weather Service has cautioned residents across five provinces about the heightened risk of wildfires due to extremely high danger conditions. Now, these conditions are particularly concerning in various areas, including parts of the Free State, the central regions of the Northern Cape, the southern areas of the Northwest, the western areas of KwaZulu-Natal, and the northwestern parts of the Eastern Cape. Now, residents are advised to exercise caution, and that's extreme caution, and adhere to fire safety protocols to prevent the outbreak and spread of wildfires during this period of heightened risk. Now, on top of this, a big reminder to share your morning views with us on our number 063-408-8860. Of course, the next hour, we will be sharing one of our top sunrise views, and that's sent in from you, Mzansi. So bring the inspiration on. But for now, though, it's time to take a look at what you can expect for your temperatures on your side of town.
Quite working up yet, but 34 Upington, come on, just let it go,
man. The seasons don't exist there, bro.
Clearly they don't. Well, every day could feel like a payday, really, and we are here for that kind of season. You could turn your Monday around with a massive bang if you play Daily Lotto today for an estimated 450,000 Rand in that jackpot, and it must be yours. Surely it could make today that payday, but you've got to play.
Yeah, man, I need to pay some bills. Let's get involved in this one, people. Now, luckily, there are many ways to buy your tickets. That's including in-store on the nationallottery.co.za website or the mobile app. Now, you can also purchase a ticket through your cell phone banking, and all you got to do is dial *120*7529# and then follow the USSDs. Simple as that.
And just one of them will suffice. You don't have to do all of them, just one of them, okay? But just make sure you do it, and we'll keep those deets up on all of the Expresso social media pages so you really have no excuses and you can do it at your leisure. Just don't wait too long. It has to happen today. You could be winning 430,000 Rand in the estimated Daily Lotto jackpot today. Please go and do it. Play now. Could be you.
It could be you indeed. Now, of course, the theme of this morning's show is just celebrating all the youngsters, the young talent that we have. We're also going to be going into the minds of these young talents. Mm. So mental well-being is of utmost importance, especially as they start paving their way to this new future that they are ultimately defining every step that they take.
Oh, for sure. It's the best kind of development, and a sport gives us so many tools to be able to do that.
100%.
And you can see a young person who's using every one of those tools right now to absolutely crush. Lamika Adamson is here with a very proud mama. Look at that smile. We love it. We're going to introduce you to, I think, one of the hottest sprinters in the country right now.
Yeah.
And certainly destined for great things. Stick around.
Yes, Mzansi, welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And feel things are going to start feeling a little bit inspiring right now, because this morning we're going to meet the dynamic Lamika Adamson. Now, she is 12 years old. Just understand this, 12 years old, and she's already a sprinting sensation. Someone is making waves in the world of athletics, breaking records, winning championships. Lamika's journey from finishing sixth to becoming a national champion is just absolutely inspiring. It's a tale of determination and hard work. And joining, of course, is her mother, Vanessa. So these two incredible souls, let's give them a big feel-good welcome! Yes! Wow, I'm in the presence of absolute greatness, and I think it's just getting started. How are both of you doing firstly this morning? Are we good? Excited? How's the body feeling?
Okay.
Okay, you rested and recovered?
Yes.
You've been through a lot, right? This has been quite a tough season for you. Before we even get into it, out of all the sports that you could do as a youngster, I mean, there's so many options. Why choose sprinting? What made you think, like, I've got some speed? What was that? When did you think, like, you could believe in yourself in this moment?
So in grade two, I started running for my school. Okay. And then I did more competitions and I was winning all my races, so I had potential in sprinting.
So really at a young age, you saw, okay, the results are starting to show. Mom, this must be quite proud. Did you think already from a young age there's got to be some sprinting talent, or did you have some in the bloodline perhaps?
Yes, definitely. That's a story. Myself and my husband are both Western Province athletes.
Woo! Cut from pedigree.
And her siblings as well, her brother.
Okay.
And her sister. So I've got three kids and all three of them are athletes.
Okay, so does it feel like pressure for you coming into a family where everybody's basically runners?
Yes.
Okay, but clearly you can deal with the pressure, because not only last year were you the under-11 champ, but this year you did something incredible. Talk to me about the primary school national championships. What went down? What exactly are we celebrating for those that have been living under a rock?
So when I went to last year's nationals, I remember that the year before I didn't medal. Mm. And I was motivated and determined to medal last year, and I did.
What was the initial feeling? Obviously, you're going in there last year wanting to get the result, but you don't. And that's often a moment that can, for someone as young as you, can kind of like deter you from the sport and make you think, oh, sixth place, that's so far away, I'm never going to be good enough. What stopped you from giving up and actually caused you to keep working harder? Because that's a very defining moment for a lot of athletes.
I just told myself to keep working hard and training to get a medal.
Don't give up.
Yes.
Mom, you think you got anything to do with this attitude?
You know what? Yes, we've been a daddy. He's a bigger supporter. He's like a second coach.
And biggest fan, I hope, as well?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So he's by your side through everything. But what stood out most for us was when she actually came sixth at her first competition. Yeah. She was 10, so that was the first time she competed at nationals. So for her, the journey was she won every race leading up to nationals, and then ending sixth. But we knew as a parents she had the potential and she had to medal. Mm. But, you know, it's a young age of 10, it's your first time. I think it was overwhelming and so forth. So we knew she had it in her. And when we saw the tears and the disappointment, the next year when she started training, I could see the determination in her. We obviously motivated her, but she was really determined to come back stronger.
She wanted it the most, and that's the most important thing, and wanted it enough to come back so strong and claim that title. And I feel like you're just getting started, right? You a provincial record holder, a SA national title holder. You 12 years old, we're just getting started. What are your goals? What are you wanting to still achieve? Because I know there's still so much that you can take advantage of. Watching some visuals now, you look like you are going to be a superstar. Talk to me about the next steps. Where do you want to be in the future?
So I want to defend my title every year, and then hopefully one day run in the Olympics for South Africa.
Is it going to be the 100 meter, 200 meter, 400 maybe? What do you think?
100 and 200.
100. And I need you to, like, not just say this. I want you to take this moment right now and visualize yourself running that race, being at the Olympics, being on that podium, wearing that SA tracksuit. Can you picture it? Can you picture it? You've got to say yes with confidence.
Yes.
Come on, because I can. I can see you there. All right, but listen, I want to say thank you so much for coming through. You really are doing something incredible at such a young age. And I know this might be a tough question, but there's a lot of youngsters, I think, especially females right now, probably watching and being like, wow, I recognize her. She's already doing so well. How do I do what she is doing right now? How would you encourage youngsters to try and not give up when they don't get the result, just like you did? to keep pushing and to try and focus on the goal? How would you try and encourage youngsters? What would your advice be?
I would probably say work hard, stay motivated and don't give up.
I love that. Moms, anything else you want to add to that, or maybe just to add to Lamika in terms of her journey so far?
Yeah, you know, it's been so exciting. Mm. Really, for me, it's goosebumps every time I see her run. Yeah. I get goosebumps. It never gets old. It's like every race is new, and you don't know what's going to happen. And she just improves with every race. She has a run personal best with every competition. She has improved, and that is why she was breaking records this year compared to last year. But you know what is more exciting is, like you say, being a role model. Mm. Every time she enters a stadium, she has to take pics. and it's so funny to think that people are, even adults, are calling her aside, can we have a pic with you? Can you have a pic with you, Lamika? And I said, Lamika, you must get used to this now.
Get used to the
she's
fame.
Very shy. She's very shy. So I said, you must start getting used to this because you are a role model. You know, this is you've been called, this is your talent, and you need to share it with the world. And people are already inspired, so you can only take it further.
100%. But the only pressure that I'm going to put on you is that I want you to make sure that no matter where you are on your journey, that you continue to enjoy the sport, enjoy the blessings that you have, enjoy the success, and be present in every moment because, oh, it's going to be a great ride. Well, future champions right here, and I'm sure we're going to see this face again, and I'm sure we're going to celebrate the rest of the youngsters on the show right now. So let's dive into some more great conversation with G-Man, and then we can start celebrating some more of the talented youth that we have in our country. Great stuff, all done.
Oh, I love that. From the fastest man on stand to the fastest young lady on tot, we are here for that kind of inspiration this morning. Now, of course, cool people like that, they get friends just because they're cool. We get friends because we know cool people, and, oh, this is a big one. Ending off April in a celebratory mode, all thanks to Samsung. Yes, they're the best friends to have. They're gearing up to give us deals that we cannot, and I mean cannot miss. I think we may need a little drum roll for this one. I don't know if I'm going to get
I hear it.
There we go. Come on, buddy. The fastest hands on wood as well. Samsung is celebrating 18 years as the global number one TV, and with good reason. And will be giving us the chance to shop live to join in on the fun. Just imagine.
Bro.
Just me, okay? Insane. Just imagine. Not you, it's not me, Ryle. It's just me, okay? On my own with my phone, my laptop, and I'm looking for my favorite Samsung appliance that I've been dying to get my hands on, but I now can get it simply with the touch of a button live on the show on Expresso this Thursday. That's the 25th of April. That's actually my wife and my son's birthday as well. All I'm saying, guys, let me press the button. Let me press the button. Oh my word, dude.
Listen, this is incredible,
it's
bro.
Gonna get crazy,
like,
bro.
We are living in the future, and I think this is absolutely incredible because look, we've had the pleasure of like filling not only our homes, but our beautiful studio in style and flair. We've got some of the great Samsung appliances. And obviously, with all your encounters and experiences, what do you love most about the appliances and their customization features that gives each customer a unique experience? Now, this is something that we could probably discuss forever.
Well, we've spent about a year discussing it on the show with good reason, really, because every time we introduce a new piece, I mean, the TVs are just insane. And I think once the Q came into the mix and I actually saw the quantum leap forward in the technology with the curve, with everything, just mind-blowing. The gaming monitors, next level. It makes me want to be a gamer. I wish that I was better at it so I could justify spending the kind of money on a premium product like that because it's next level. Yeah. But as weird as it sounds, I know, because we deal with this kind of frontier of where design meets functionality. When you've got appliances that are this good, that are this beautiful, like the bespoke fridge, the microwave, that's not a microwave, it's a convection oven, it's an air fryer.
It's the solution to life, man.
Exactly. but I think the thing that's going to blow us all away, and you're seeing it emerging more now, the Internet of Things. I like being able to use my tablet as a remote for my TV, yo.
and again, I know I'm not going to dive in this conversation too much, but I actually had an opportunity to go overseas and see some of the future tech that's Samsung are using. Oh my
mind
gosh,
blood.
It's gonna be your mind. You're not ready.
All right, so well, you better start getting ready because you do not want to miss Expresso this Thursday for a phenomenal, I mean truly phenomenal, Samsung deal for your home right in your home.
Oh, it's going to be good. Listen, we're going to keep the good, keeping on right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. I'm going to probably need to get changed soon. I've got a workout that's coming through in a bit. So it's an upper body workout. I know that everybody loves to get their sweat on, get your gains on a Monday. So we have just that in store for you, man.
Yeah, and there's some stacked young'uns out there. So the youngsters be training hard from a young age, and we love that. But what we love the most about sport is the opportunity to build character. Mm. And we're going to delve into an incredible organization that are using sport, that mode, to do amazing things with young people, to heal those emotional wounds so that the body can perform at its peak. That's why we love sport, especially in the South African context. We'll introduce you to these incredible human beings on the other side of this.
Are you auditioning and getting ready for Tropica Island of Treasure? Well, don't let joint and muscular pain hold you back. DeepEat is your go-to warm-up solution and SA's number one choice.
Oh, yes, and here's an extra incentive. The top seven contestants heading to the island will each receive 10,000 Rand from DeepEat. And remember, you can upload your audition with the hashtag DeepEat and the hashtag Tropica and tag MyTropica.
Who knows? You could be competing in Zanzibar.
Yeah, it's time to reach your full potential.
Get DeepEat and conquer the island.
We promised you an inspirational morning. Welcome back as the inspiration hits overload. This morning, we are diving into an inspiring story of resilience and transformation with the School of Hard Knocks Youth Organization. They're officially called the School of Hard Knocks. And I know that's kind of like the whole of South Africa, okay? But these guys are getting it right. Joining us are Urshman Engel and Ntutu Ndongeni, two clearly passionate coaches from this organization who are committed to supporting young, impressionable minds and helping them navigate the tough times that life is going to throw at all of us. And they are going to be talking about their different programs available to empower amazing young people, because these people must be amazing to inspire you to be doing this. So thank you so much to both of you for doing what you do. School of Hard Knocks, baby, it's tough out there. And this is the reality. I think, and maybe Urshman, I can start with you, because not many people take that step from realizing, understanding where communities are, where young people in South Africa are, the step to doing something about it. This feels, you've got the coolest name, first of all, let's tick that box. But how did this come about?
So this program, it started a couple of years back, 2019. And the reason why it started, it was just to kind of help kids reach matric. It was just an extra thing to see.
I love that.
To help kids reach matric. And as time passed, we noticed that that's not the only problem in South Africa. We have a bigger problem.
It's a rabbit hole once you go down.
Yeah, once you go in there, you'll see how it opens up and there's so much more things. And what we then, we changed our vision and mission then to something more based on what was needed in Cape Town, in South Africa. And that's where we changed from trying to get kids to reach matric to saying, wait, it's not everybody that needs to reach matric. Some people are in a different line of life. So what we then changed our vision was to helping everyone reach their full potential. through the different programs, through being trauma-informed, through using the mental health programs so that they can reach their full potential.
I love that, because you've kept it simple and so practical. And the crazy thing is, from my vantage point here of dealing with so many trauma-based organizations, the trauma doesn't come from the act, it comes from the lack of processing or education or awareness. You've got to understand what's going on around you to be able to deal with that. Sport can give us so many of these tools to be able to do that. And Tutu, how do you guys use your basic education, your understanding of that space and sport? How do you blend that together to do the work that you do?
Well, speaking from the trauma that you mentioned, we have also realized as the School of Hard Knocks that trauma can have such a detrimental impact on a person's like potential.
For sure.
And by incorporating the sports with the education, we try as much as we can by using our psychological sessions to embed it with a touch rugby-based activity, for example. Just so that it can stick with the participant that we are working with, brilliant, as well as also using that education that they receive from the school to also try and incorporate that into the session as well.
I love that. This is giving them a model that they can utilize at any phase of their life. There's a reason why we bring the Brian Abanas back and use them in business. Why? Because these skills are so transferable. And then you've got your brothers and your sisters around you while you're doing it and a mentor. Begs the question, why? Why do you do this? How do your past experiences colour your role in this organisation?
Okay, so my past experience, I used to work in an area called Hanover Park.
Yeah.
And most people would know that that was one of the most violent
gets
areas.
It's real very quick.
Yeah, yes. And working in Hanover Park, I worked for an organisation that worked with gangs and tried to like do conflict mediations with the gangs. And in that organisation, it was kind of heartbreaking watching people, so many of these gangs wanting to change their lives, wanting an option out, but because of the choices they made and certain commitments they made, it's kind of too late for them. And being in that, going through that emotional roller coaster up and down, you see this participant flourishing in life, and then all of a sudden, he just gets, something happens to him. So working with that, it was stressful for me. It was too much for me. And I was like, how do I change this narrative? And then I researched, because I decided I don't want to become reactive. Every time something happens, then we react only. I wanted to become more proactive, and in my own personal vision, it was the next spot you need to go to is school, Ershwin, because the gangs are being taken out of school, so you need to be there before they get into the gangs. And found School of Hard Knocks, and then I was like, this is perfect. This is where I need to be.
And it is, because you're so right. These gateways are so vitally important, but you overcome that. Mm. You've kind of got a superpower, because you'll have that mental strength, that resilience, and we see it in our communities every day. And Tutu, maybe I can round off with you. Your vision, the goal for the future for you, and it may be advice for other people playing in your space. What would you like to achieve with this incredible organisation, this movement that's starting to form around you?
I feel like growing up, we don't really have like the people that we necessarily are as now. So the one thing that I always live by is I always try to be the person that I never had when I was younger, or the person that I particularly needed when I was younger.
For sure.
So I'd say that by being in the space that I'm in, by planting the seed basically with the next person, because I can't just now tell you about trauma and then tell you and give you the coping tools and then just walk away. You have to go and take that and use it to the next person. So I'm hoping that by the time that we, by the end of this year maybe, there are going to be a lot of lives that we have changed that they can also like go and change, whether it's in their homes or within their communities as well.
Yeah, and that's quantum change. That's where we start taking the money at the top and connecting it to the young people at the bottom, and we shift that baseline up. And it's amazing to see things like this come together in this space, and this must be taken as manifestation of what you're doing working, guys. There is a reason why you're sitting out on TV preaching this message to the nation. Literally, this is exactly what the country needs right now. Purpose-driven organizations making a massive difference. Now, I'm hoping Ryle is imbued with the same level of purpose, because TJ's in the house and his arms are looking big. It's time for an upper body workout. Good luck, son.
Oh, yeah, it's Pompetti time, baby. This morning, we're going to be jumping into a beginner-friendly upper body workout, and that means everybody can join. Yes, that's you listening right now. Don't be intimidated. We've got you, and it's time for you to get ready to sculpt those arms, those shoulders, your back, and everything else with this easy-to-follow exercise designed to kickstart your fitness journey. So whether you're starting your journey or maybe just want some extra stimulation, this is going to be perfect for you. And, of course, the one and only that's taking us through this amazing workout is personal trainer, TJ Bombetti Jones in the building.
Thank you.
How are you, bro?
Oh, yourself?
I'm good, man. I want some of these buys for this morning. Serve it up, man. How are we getting it going?
All right, so we're going to start off with an easy workout, starting off with a modified push-ups, laying down on the ground.
All right.
If you want to get your push-up game up, starting off on the ground with our chest down, all we're going to do is we're pushing straight up, all right, then going back down onto the ground. If this is a bit more challenging, we're going to modify it further. Where we're going on our knees, just pushing up, keeping your knees onto the ground. Ooh. And back down. All right, we're gonna do 10 of those normal ones, knees up. Are you ready?
Yep.
And let's get it.
All right, TJ, what exactly are we focusing on when we're doing this push-up? What muscles are working here, man?
So your secondary muscles working are your triceps to do all the pushing. And then your chest is your primary muscle, which we tend to target.
Okay, definitely feeling both of those right now.
That's good.
Probably about 6 reps or more in. But I like the fact that you're going nice and slow, making that control count. Every rep is a proper workout. We're not rushing through this one.
Yep.
Very nice stuff, man. That's important, obviously, right?
Yep, that's it. Do you want to get that contraction? You got to slow it down.
I like that. Right. And that's where you get the gains. All right, so step one, we've got that exercise. When we're doing this at home, how many sort of exercises or how many of those should we do?
So you do want to keep it as simple as possible. 5 exercises. 4 sets per exercise.
4 sets. So we're going to do like 4 sets of those, right?
4 sets of
rep
those.
Rep count, 10 reps.
10 reps.
Love
depending
it.
On your goal.
Let's keep it going, man.
Next up, we've got our bicep curls. Nice and simple.
Oh, nice.
Right here. Try and keep your elbows tucked in close to your body. All you're going to do is come up, get that contraction squeezed. Do not lift your elbows up. Keep it close to your body. All right, we're going to go 10 reps. All the way up. Squeeze. And back down.
This one, I tend to keep quite quiet for, because this is about mind-muscle connection right here, man.
Definitely.
I always feel like if you can get that focus on the bicep and
you
really
get the best squeeze.
Yeah, yep. Get that peak contraction. You're sort of adding some extra value to those gains. So a real good tip there, I think. I don't know if you agree with that. Do you certify that one?
Yep, no, okay. Definitely.
All right, then it's facts. Then it's facts for sure. If CJ's certifying that one. And again, 10 reps with this?
10 reps as well.
Nice.
And depending on your goal.
Keeping the control. We're kind of keeping that tempo. Nothing
nice
too crazy.
And slow.
I love it. This is also something I can see beginners really enjoying because this is not too over intimidating, I think, at the same time.
Quite
anyone
simple.
Can manage this, and you can kind of progress with the weights too.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
All right. Biceps coming in. We've done the chest, we've done the tries, we've got the buys ready, ticking so many boxes, but we're only 2 exercises in.
Yeah.
It's a good bang for your buck, man. All right, what's next?
All right, next up, we've got the resistant band pull rows.
I'm always interested in how people use these bands because you can do so many things with them, right?
Right, so if you have a pole, you can use this, or if you have a friend and a partner working out with you, all we're gonna do is keep our elbows in. We're not contracting the back with this, with having our elbows up, we're contracting it with having our elbows in. So all we're gonna do is pull backwards. You're
pulling together?
Yep.
Oh, right wow, there. Feel that tension.
So stability of the core as well.
This is pretty cool, man. It's like a partnered workout as well.
Exactly.
I like the fact that we have to focus on each other, making sure that we're also not rushing the movement. This is fantastic. Bro, I'm getting a great feeling in my like sort of lower middle back. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Oh, this is form. And again, 10 reps of these in total.
10 reps as well.
TJ, this is fun stuff, man. Again, I would rather opt for not using a pole if we have the option and definitely get a friend involved in this one because this is going to keep you both accountable at the same time. And it looks like fun, bro.
It is
nice.
Fun.
10 reps in the bag. Feeling like, oh, we got the gains already, man. And we're only like 1 round in. I love it, dude. So essentially, we're going to do about 5 rounds of that.
Yeah.
Brilliant stuff. That's pretty simple, pretty easy. And if you want any more tips, guys, then this man, Bombetti, is at your service. He's got a plethora of exercises and skills to replicate these biceps right here. So reach out to the man. And brother, thank you so much for coming through. I think after a hard workout like that, we've earned one thing indeed.
Yo, let's bro, okay?
All right.
Thank you, man. That, guys, turn around and look at the picture they've had up this whole time. They did you guys are dirty here. I'm so sorry.
Like, come on. Maybe it's like it's the before and the after.
Yeah, exactly.
There we go. But listen, after that workout, I'm feeling absolutely incredible. Thank you so much. Cheers to that. Sanzi, I hope you enjoyed your first start to your fitness journey. And if you want more, then reach out to this man. He's got you covered. Cheers. Nice, bro.
All right, so I've literally just introduced myself to this incredible human being. It is Santi Naidoo. She's doing what I think so many people in my industry dream of doing, even at this age, conquering Hollywood. She's found a route and she is going to slay. How are you doing this morning?
Good, and yourself?
Oh, very good. And she's going to inspire us. And then we've got Chrissy J. De Beer in the house ready to perform. She is young, but she is oh so talented and she is blazing a trail. Good morning, young lady. She's going to be introducing herself to the world in just a moment and, of course, performing just for, well, for all of us, but mainly just for you. Stick around.
Drained? Dehydrated? You have lost more than just fluid. Recover faster. Add Rehydrate, SA's number one oral electrolyte mixture.
Sermon over or what? You ever think about moving away from here?
No. My dad loves this place.
Give me my shoe.
Hey, Jerome! Take it easy on my boy.
All right. Check it out then.
Let's go check up, man.
What's good, blood? What's good, Chris? What's good, GD? What's good, King? I cannot kill, if that's your thing. Sometimes blood ain't thicker, dog, than what you think. People, they come, they go.
Welcome back. We promised you inspiration and we've got it in spades. Joining us right now is a young superstar, Chrissy J. De Beer. You might have heard the name already. You might have picked it up during lockdown when we were all desperate to see talented people doing things online. Well, she did it and she's made her mark. She's a singer, she's an actor, she's a dancer, she's a model, and she is shining bright at the moment, and I think she's shining that light on all areas of the entertainment industry, and she is making her mark wherever she goes, and I expect today will be no different. Can, I know we don't have a live studio audience, but can my cameraman give her a big round of applause? Welcome to see. You are awesome, first of all, which is cool. My daughter always says the coolest thing when she's just feeling empowered. She says, I look pretty and cool. You are pretty and cool. You've got it down. But you are so young, and I say that with all due respect. You have taken a big leap of faith on your talent. Why? What was that thing that inspired you to go out there and put your talents out there to the world?
When I was little, I always loved to perform. I always wanted to perform. And when I was little, I used to, like, sing little songs on my parents' coffee table.
It's a perfect stage.
And after that, my parents thought, you know what? Let's enroll her in an agency.
Yeah, yeah.
And they did that, and from then on, it has just been happy days and rainbows for me.
And I love the fact, I've never seen someone so serious saying, and rainbows, okay? Because it is like that. I've got to ask how it feels when you do this, when you get to sing or perform, whether it's in front of my five cameramen or a room full of people, whether you're doing it in your room, what is it about performing that makes you so happy?
Just to really be on a stage or just looking in the mirror, looking at myself performing a talent that God has blessed me.
Yeah, yeah.
Just feels amazing. It makes me feel powerful.
I love it. It makes you look powerful as well. And you've got to hold on to these feelings because that's what you've got to let out when you're performing. That's what we buy into. And we get to get, I suppose, a little piece of you with your single, Pieces of Me. Talk me through that song. What was the kind of message behind the song? Give me a bit of background.
So in 2020, we had just begun to get ready for IMTA.
Okay.
And if you don't know what that is, it is a talent competition found anywhere in the world, but we went to go perform in New York.
Ooh.
And due to COVID, we couldn't go in 2020 or 2021. So it took us 3 years to get to the point where we could actually go. And throughout that time, we made songs, we were preparing for it. And once it finally came, it was amazing. It was fantastic. And to see all of those big buildings in New York, seeing all of the different faces was...
It's a different world.
A different world. And I did win medals and that and all of that sort of stuff. But what really counted was the memories you made.
For sure. I love that. And you've just gotten started. I think of the moments that I've had with amazing performers, sharing a stage with them in these incredible moments. You've got so many of those coming your way. I've got to ask, because there are young people out there that are looking at you saying, I wish I had the confidence to do that. I wish I had the talent. And often people don't realize that they do. They just need to be brave enough to take that step. What advice do you have for other young performers wanting to follow in your footsteps?
Never give up on your dreams and always follow them. And at one stage, a door is gonna open where you can actually fulfill those dreams. And if anything bad happens, use those bad things as a power.
I love it. That is the South African superpower right there. You turn adversity into triumph, like I just did, trying to say that word. The bottom line is, it's within you. And Chrissy is going to be proving that for us this morning. You're an absolute superstar. You are pretty and cool. Absolutely amazing to see the potential of young South Africans who are brave enough to step up and take their opportunity.
Yeah, we're going to step up right now and dive into another conversation, someone that has grabbed the bull by the horns. Now, listen, as a nation, we have incredible minds and, let's be honest, creatives bursting with potential. And someone making us proud on the international scale is a young woman, and she's only in her 20s. We're talking about Santi Naidu, who has a BA from UCT and graduated cum laude with a postgraduate degree in film and television studies. Look at these titles just rolling in. Now, she has been living in LA, I'm talking about Los Angeles, for the past 2.5 years. And her American Film Institute thesis film, Misalignment, has done the festival circuit, along with her short Jerome, which was recently up for consideration for the 96th Academy Awards. Yes, you are hearing this correctly. I think we need to put our hands together for this incredible soul. That's insane. Sadie, how are you doing this morning?
Good, and yourself?
I'm fantastic. I'm like just getting excited. I'm getting inspired. I'm like, what? South Africans are doing these things? And I should stop doubting myself actually when I say that, because the bar's been set and I think we deserve these accolades. But let's take it to the beginning. Film, why were you drawn to this? Why did you try and make a career out of this? How, who, what, why, where, when?
Yeah,
this is
yeah.
a crazy decision, but I'm here for it.
Film started really early on for me. Okay. I think I always loved photography and capturing images and people's stories. I think that always inspired me. It was until high school when I really was like, oh, okay, this is a lot more than just a hobby. It's something that I'm passionate about. I got to be on the film crew and do all the fun little things that you do in high school. And then when it's time to apply for university, it was, okay, now I have to actually look at things realistically. In South Africa, the creative arts are very much underfunded and a difficult industry to get into. So I was like, let me not put all my eggs in one basket. And I did a couple of other majors at UCT, but film was one of them because I wanted it to be an option. From there, I did my honors degree at UCT as well, and then applied during the pandemic to the American Film Institute in LA to just further my studies after I'd done some work in South Africa and just wanted to touch the international market a little bit more.
And you got the stamp of approval, clearly, right? I mean, not to speak of the challenges and the negativities behind the industry, but there are a lot of challenges, right? It's not that easy to just, okay, I'll apply and go pop into LA. It's not that simple. I mean, that's just one of the steps that you have to go through. But You're someone that has already, I think, achieved so much. You're just getting started, but I think you've got a good recipe. Talk to me about some of the other challenges that you've already had to overcome, and I feel like you're just still getting started in this game.
Yeah, I think a big thing of especially trying to make it in the international scene is that you're really far from home and what's familiar. So a lot of things are new and you're discovering a lot about yourself but also about the rest of the world. I think a lot of it also as a young person of color, it can be tough in an industry that is so predominantly like racially fueled and has historically in South Africa been something that's really intense. I think it is now moving into a space where it's becoming a little easier, but it is still very difficult to reach those really higher marks. But I think it's starting at a grassroots level in South Africa, and we're seeing more media programs in schools and stuff like that, which is what really sets up the young people to be able to look forward to making it overseas and trying to build a career in the arts for themselves. So.
And you've got to constantly keep chipping away.
Yes.
And you sometimes get rewarded when you chase your passion, when you find that talent and you exercise it, and you execute it in such a beautiful way. I mean, let's talk about this short, Jerome. This is huge. Was I correct in saying that it was nominated for what I believe is, or considered for an Oscar at least? This is like, are you aware of this? Did you have to pinch yourself when you realized this moment was like real? My short film? Like, what was that feeling like?
It takes a bit to realize how long and how much it takes to get considered for an Oscar. There's a whole bunch of festivals and a whole bunch of processes that you have to go through. And when it did happen, it was kind of like, oh, this is real. This has actually happened. And we're moving on into this thing. And hopefully the project goes further than that. But that alone was something really exciting.
And I think for your entire career, it's something exciting. I'm so looking forward to whatever else you touch, because I feel like it's just going to turn to gold. I feel like one day I'm going to put out a manifestation there that I get to work with you in the acting space doing something incredible.
Anytime.
So let's make this happen for sure. I want to quickly ask you a question, though, because we have you, we have your talent and your energy. Any advice for those aspiring filmmakers, those that want to get into the scene, that have now seen that it's possible and seen someone like you pave the way? What advice do you have for them?
I think to just make things. We make things and they're bad and then we get discouraged from making things again. I think to go out with your friends and find your people that work well with you in that environment and to just continuously chip away at making something that is exciting to you, then that's a good way to start. Eventually, after making things so many times over, hopefully one time you make something that's really good.
It's not a matter of hope, it's a matter of time. If you keep doing this, then of course it's going to happen. Thank you so much again for coming through.
Thank you.
I look forward to the next few projects that you definitely will be working on, and purely nothing but the best of success.
Thank you.
For you, Mzansi, of course, this is the inspiration we came for. I'm grateful that these journeys get to be shared, but I'm grateful that we still have so much more to look forward to right now, right here, on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
So who is Chrissy J. De Beer? Well, it's her, okay? Remember that name. She's going to perform for us in just a moment. She is doing everything she can within the entertainment space, and she's absolutely nailing it. Cannot wait to introduce her talent to you. And then, of course, in celebration of World Earth Day, we're looking at innovative ways of tackling plastic. And we have got the notion of a reverse vending machine now entering the fray. It sounds absolutely amazing, a little mind-blowing. Stick around for that.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Oh, welcome back. We are loving our Mondays. A few weeks ago, we started introducing you to incredible young South Africans. We introduced you to Lamika, a sprinter. I could see you were like, oh, man.
Blown away.
Oh, man. Absolute, like, just dominance on every space. And now, of course, we've got someone on our stage standing by right now.
Standing by is Chrissy J. De Beer performing one of her songs called Beautiful Life and a cover by Olivia Rodrigo, which is called Can't Catch Me Now. Well, officially, I'm going to hand the stage over to this young superstar.
Hi guys, it's Chrissy J. De Beer, and I'm now going to sing one of my first songs. Well, in 2023, I wrote this song called Beautiful Life. Can't wait for you to hear it.
Sorry, I'm supposed to be working out here, but I can't help from enjoying myself. That's Chrissy J, an absolutely incredible talent that is not going anywhere, Mzansi. So stick around for more of that. And can you believe how young these talents are, just getting started in their careers and already sounding like superstars? For now, though, it's 1 minute past the hour. Official duties must commence, and it's time for some national news headlines. Now, starting off with Fly SAF Air, yesterday confirmed that one of its flights, FA212, from Johannesburg to Cape Town, was required to return to Johannesburg after its wheel was damaged during takeoff. Now, the airline said the aircraft left OR Tambo International Airport on a schedule at 11:32 a.m. But after takeoff, ground staff at OR Tambo reported witnessing what appeared to be damage to one of the aircraft's back wheels. Now, a quote coming through saying the crew were alerted to the observation and the decision was taken to return to Johannesburg. And this being said by FlySafair spokesperson Kirby Gordon. Well, next up in our national headlines is Mvelu. KwaZulu-Natal Wildlife says they have started an immediate program to dehorn hundreds of rhinos in the province. Now, this to stop widespread rhino poaching. Now, this as KZN recorded a high number of rhino poaching cases, with 325 killed in the past year alone. Now, the spokesperson for Mvelu KwaZulu-Natal Wildlife, Musa Mtambo, says poaching in the province has been extremely rife. Now, 109 rhinos have been killed since the beginning of this year, and he says the dehorning process will not have any significant impact on the rhinos. Well, we now move over to international headlines, and President Vladimir Zelensky has expressed his gratitude to the U.S. House of Representatives for approving a new $61 billion package for military assistance for the Ukraine, and this after months of delay. Now, he said the aid could save thousands of lives, and to much delayed measure had vocal opponents in Congress, and it took a fragile bipartisan to deal past the $61 billion package. Now, Republicans said more than a third would be dedicated to replenishing weapons and ammunition, and this would most likely include air defense systems, mid to long range missiles, and artillery shells. Well, next up in our headlines, at least 58 people on their way to a funeral have died after their overloaded riverboat capsized on the Mpoko River in the Central African Republic on Saturday. Now, people who rushed to assist were able to extract 58 lifeless bodies, but at the time of the rescue attempts did not know how many people had landed in the river. Now, witnesses said the wooden boat was carrying some 300 people, while some standing and others perched on wooden structures when it capsized. Now, our condolences definitely go out to all those affected, but we move on to our final headline for the hour. Now, in a luminous ambience of New York's Times Square, Nigerian chess master Tunde Onokayo on Friday broke the record for the longest chess marathon by playing continuously for 58 hours. Now, his marathon aimed to raise $1 million for charity, specifically supporting chess education for children. Now, surrounded by hundreds of supporters, including Nigerian Afrobeat star Davido, Onokayo received musical encouragement and sustenance with classic Nigerian dishes such as jollof rice. Now, the previous record stood at 56 hours, which was set in 2018 by Onokayo's dedication, but it was rooted in his personal journey from poverty in Lagos to chess advocacy, which has drawn global attention to initiatives such as Chess in Slums Africa and The Gift of Chess, all underscoring the transformative power of chess education. Well, incredible stuff indeed, but we've got more headlines to get through, and here's G-Man with the latest when it comes to all things sport.
Oh, thank you so much. Well, after that inspirational story, let's dive right in with some FA Cup action. And Bernardo Silva's late goal that propelled Man City into the FA Cup finals with a 1-0 victory over Chelsea. We know Chelsea have become specialists in this kind of cup lane, but despite a challenging match, Silva's decisive strike securing the holders a win. Then in our other thrilling semi-final, Manchester United, they just edged past Coventry City, suddenly punching above their weight class, and they had to do it on penalties after a dramatic 3-3 draw in extra time. Incredible. But United's perseverance paid off as Rasmus Højlund's penalty sealed their spot in the final up against their old foes, Manchester City. It's going to be a physical affair, but we love the sound of that. Not so much the results coming out of the URC this weekend. In the latest round of the URC, the Lions shone bright and alone, pretty much, with a dominant 44-12 bonus point victory over log leaders Leinster. Can I just say to Robbie Gillette, he called it on Friday. And they, of course, secured the sole triumph for the South African franchises this weekend. So disappointment loomed as the Sharks fell 21-10 to the Glasgow Warriors. Then the Bulls, uncharacteristically, they suffered a 27-22 defeat at the hands of an albeit very strong Munster side. And then the Stormers just couldn't find that clinical edge. They were defeated 27-21 by the Ospreys, who found another gear down in Cape Town. So as a result, the Bulls, now they dropped to fourth place, while the Stormers, they slipped to sixth. But the Lions, they, with that win, keep themselves in contention for a quarterfinal spot, while the Sharks, they hold on to 13th place on the logs. Then we turn to tennis, and speaking of perseverance and resilience, world number six Casper Ruud clinched a victory at the Barcelona Open, defeating his old foe Stefanos Tsitsipas 7-5, 6-3 in a commanding performance. So the win marked a sweet revenge for the round after the loss to Tsitsipas, of course, in the Monte Carlo Masters just a week ago. The Norwegian, with 11 career titles, including now the Barcelona Open, secured what must be the biggest trophy of his career. Despite three previous final losses, Ruud's perseverance paying off with his first title of 2024, and you can see on his face what it meant to him, solidifying his position as a force to be reckoned with on the tour this year. Now, a force of, well, unlike any other right now, it must be said. Max Verstappen capped off another commanding weekend by clinching victory at the first Chinese Grand Prix in 5 years, further solidifying now his lead in the world championship. So after a dominant sprint victory, the three-time world champion then controlled the race at the Shanghai International Circuit, which looked great. And he finished 13.7 seconds ahead of Lando Norris and Sergio Perez, making up the rest of the podium. So Verstappen's near-perfect weekend was only marred by the disruptor Fernando Alonso, is still working his magic, his late dash for the fastest lap. But with this fourth Grand Prix win of the season, as early as it is, Verstappen continuing to assert his dominance out on the track. That gap getting pretty wide now. But that's where we leave our sport for now. Hopefully the gap's a little bit wider in the traffic this morning. Let's get you the latest on the traffic front before the weather.
Thank you, G-Man. Yes, lots to discuss when it comes to traffic, and starting off in Germiston, Johannesburg. Now, there's been a motor vehicle accident on the N12 westbound, and this before Gelulis interchange. Now, as you can see from the visuals, the left lane is affected. So please, if you're passing through the area, do allow for more travel time and exercise caution while driving. We're going to stick to Johannesburg and Germiston, because there's been an accident on the N3 northbound once again, as you can see, before the ramp to Linksfield interchange. Now, the left lane is closed, and again, it is causing slow-moving traffic, so exercise caution when passing through. Now, sticking to Johannesburg once again and over to Randburg, there is congestion on the N1 northbound, and this before Malebungwe Drive and Beyers Nordea Drive. Again, maintaining a safe following distance is encouraged, and for anybody heading out the roads this morning, buckle up, stay safe, and plan accordingly. From the road to the sky, let's find out now what's happening when it comes to weather. Diving into the world of weather from tomorrow, planned maintenance by Cape Town's Water and Sanitation Directorate can cause up to 10-hour water supply disruptions in several areas. Now, affected regions include Milnerton, Ridgeworth, Bloemhof, Century City, Canal Walk, and Helena Heights in Somerset West. Now, this maintenance will temporarily halt water supply in these areas. And additionally, residents in the northern parts of the mother city are urged to conserve water, as the Fulflay water treatment plant undergoes routine maintenance. Now, this is going to be affecting reservoirs supplying Durbanville, Versantekraal, Klipheerville, Uitzicht, Pinehurst, and Saunstraalhoogte. Now, the city plans to replenish reservoirs before the shutdown, and that's to mitigate the impact on water availability during this period. Well, from our weather news, we dive into one of our favorite parts of the morning. That's our sunrise view of the hour. Now, let us celebrate together a shot by Buddy Govender all the way in Durban. Now, look at this. A beautiful shot silhouetting a tree right there in the background, but it's the glow for me, the artistic glow of orange hues coming through, just illuminating the sky and giving that promise of a beautiful day. And that's what it's all about. These sunrise views are what we love to celebrate, so keep it coming. We'll do it again in the next hour. The number's 063-408-8863. For now though, let's have a look at what temperatures you can expect on your side of town. Thank you.
Yes, Uppington, it is still going to be a hot one, so stay indoors just a little bit longer and start thinking about those lucky numbers. Why? Because you could end Monday with a very big bang if you play Daily Lotto for an estimated 430,000 Rand in the jackpot today. It could be your very own payday. All you need to do is, of course, play. So luckily, there are many ways that you can get your hands on your tickets, including in-store, probably the simplest. You can go to nationallottery.co.za. That's their website. You can stop by their mobile app, which is really easy to use. You can even purchase your tickets via your own cell phone banking app. There's a really easy little drop-down. Or you can simply go old school and dial *120*7529# for the USSD. All these details will be kept up on our special social media pages, so you've got no excuses. Go and check them out at your leisure. And just most importantly, put yourself in the running to win big. Will the 430,000 Rand in estimated Daily Lotto jackpots be hitting your way? Well, you've got to play now to find out. And while you ponder those lucky numbers, we're going to take a very quick break. You can go refill your coffee cup. When we're back, more Monday inspiration. This morning, we're going to introduce you to some incredible people doing incredible things. And one of those, tackling plastic and plastic waste in a very innovative new way. And of course, that's to celebrate World Earth Day, an opportunity for all of us to galvanize and do something. Then we're back in the kitchen to whip up some butternut done very differently this morning. How gorgeous does that look? We'll give you the play-by-play after this. Oh, you can make my
it's my feel-good
breakfast show. Welcome back to what has been a very inspirational Monday morning with quite a nice practical edge beneath it. So let's go on that train right now. This Earth Day, we are putting the spotlight on, it's a groundbreaking initiative to tackle plastic waste here in South Africa, and there is a lot. Imagined Earth is taking recycling to a completely new space by rewarding customers for recycling with their innovative reverse vending machines. I love it. And here in studio to tell us a little bit more is Sam Bennett, the waste strategist behind Imagined Earth. Believe it or not, we share a love of waste management.
Absolutely.
It's something that excites me because it speaks to the social development arc. It speaks to something that affects all of us. So Sam, well done for doing what you're doing. There are a million questions that I want to ask, but the first I have to is, what is a reverse vending machine?
Yes.
Maybe this is a good jumping off point.
Okay, so the best way to explain it is it's exactly the opposite of a standard vending machine.
Correct.
So traditionally you would put money in and you would get a product out. We flipped that around and said, put your recycling in and we will give you money out in the form of a reward of some kind. So that's essentially, from a simplistic perspective, what it does.
Makes sense. It makes absolute logical sense. And all we need in this world is a bit of logic sometimes. Great idea.
Yeah.
Millions of ideas like this have surfaced, obviously, because there's such a great need, a challenge that needs to be answered. What made you guys take this step? How did this become a reality?
So I think a little bit of background is the founder started the first door-to-door collection recycling solution in Johannesburg 100 years ago. And, you know, it's a very difficult industry to be successful in because recycling is a commodity and rebates fluctuate.
Margins aren't massive.
Margins are very low. They're dependent on quality and quantity. And a lot of what happens in Europe specifically is reverse vending machines, and they utilize technology. It's driven by legislation, and we're getting there. We can talk about that a little bit and how important that is. But Justin, the founder, Justin Needham, went over to the UK and to Europe and had a look and saw these machines and just thought, we have a waste crisis. We're in a poverty trap. How do we solve two problems at once? And that was sort of how it was born. And that was in around sort of 2015.
And the rest is history, as they say. 140 vending machines later says to me, from a business sense, that this is working. You've gone now kind of all in the space. What's the reaction been like?
Very positive. I think one of the big things to understand is that when you talk to people about waste management, they sort of glaze over for various reasons. I mean, it's not very sexy.
Yeah.
It's not very exciting.
Someone else's job, yo.
And it's a grudge purchase. So from a business perspective and from a residential perspective, it's something that you pay for that you don't necessarily get anything
back for.
Until
it's too late, generally.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Exactly. So people have been incredibly excited about the tech aspect of it. You're utilizing a piece of equipment. It all sits on a mobile application, so that's how you cash out your rewards. It's how you communicate with people. And we all know we spend most of our times glued to our phones.
Yeah.
So, and the convenience factor. So that's a big thing. We had this conversation earlier that convenience is so important. People want to do the right thing, but not really if it's, you know.
You kind of, it's picking your battles, because there's so much going on. You think, okay, well, if I'm doing all of this there, do I really need to be thinking about waste management in this space? But it is something that affects all of us. And I think a lot of people would have gone, oh, I can get something back.
So that's the key.
How does that work? How do the incentives play out? How does the actual system work?
Okay, so importantly, when you recycle at home, if you're lucky enough to have a collection, most people don't, which means you have to pay for that
collection. I'm the guy. I do the collection for our...
You're the collection guy. So, but you're not getting anything back for that. Mm-hmm. So each material substrate does have a commercial value. And it varies depending on the type of plastic, whether it's metal, whether it's cardboard or whatever. So the value of that material goes back to the consumer who's recycled immediately into your digital wallet. Uh-huh. So the machine works on a barcode. So a Coke bottle, a water bottle, a sunlight bottle has a barcode. We scan hundreds of thousands of products in order to determine what is that material type, is it in fact recyclable, and what is the material value.
Oh, who produced it?
Oh, you don't want to know.
You see, this is the crazy thing. All this says to me is data, 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 which is amazing.
Absolutely, absolutely. And this is where you've sort of segued into the whole legislation impact. So we've got new legislation in South Africa called the Extended Producer Responsibility Legislation.
Okay.
What that does is it places the responsibility on the producer, on the brand, on the manufacturer of that packaging to be responsible financially for it to end of life.
You must know. You must know.
Exactly. Oh, they do know.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
You must be accountable now. Yeah.
So that's the difference. So now you're paying a fee. Now you're paying a fee so that that money can get ring-fenced and then go into developing the recycling economy, design for recycling, ensuring that there is infrastructure in place to be able to have a system to collect, distribute, trade.
That says jobs to me. That says 100%. Applying the tip of the spear technology. So I just get a warm, fuzzy feeling inside whenever I see consumer-driven technology being inverted and working for the people. You guys are amazing. You and I could probably sit for about 10 hours talking about the potential of a plug-in like this. I absolutely love it. Imagined Earth. We're going to keep their details up on all of our platforms. Please plug into it. If you're looking for a way of empowering your organization, your building, your company, your community, your strip mall, whatever it is, with a connection to the community that they will respond to, I have a feeling this is going to be a game changer. Well, it already is. So we are here for that. I know one man who would be very excited at what we've just spoken about. Nature Boy. Let's put in a big tick in that box, my friend.
This is what you guys are doing. Thank you so much. Massive smiles on my face. And I think all those soldiers fighting for the cause when it comes to protecting our beautiful Earth. Now, there's another cause coming up, one that is going to get you very, very excited. Yes, something exciting is coming to your screens this Thursday. We're talking about the 25th of April, 2024, right here on Expresso. We're joined by our incredible friends at Samsung. Yeah, I know that's piquing your interest already. Now, it's more than just about how it works. It really does matter about how it looks too, right? And that's especially when it comes to Samsung appliances. So how do you feel their appliances are equally as beautiful in design as they are effective and efficient in application? And that's one thing that I cannot wrap my head around more so right now when I look at all the incredible opportunities that we have, especially taking place this Thursday. Now, you've heard the hype, so you definitely want to be a part of this, especially the fact that there's going to be some great deals too. So if you've got your eye on some incredible appliances that you've been dying to get your hands on, then Thursday might just be the very day for you to show up and grab it, because these opportunities are coming through. Now, not only is this incredible opportunity coming through, but we've also got incredible performances with the one and only Chrissy still standing by. Look at that beautiful soul, ready to serve you, Mzansi. And if you were hanging around earlier, you know exactly what I'm talking about. An incredible voice and an even more illustrious talent. And that doesn't stop there, right? We've got something incredible to talk about. Obviously, it is Earth Day. We're talking about a vending machine that is no longer producing plastic. It sounds like it should have come a long time ago, but it's finally here, and we get to find out more about this amazing solution. Solution, entertainment, everything for you, right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
So welcome back. We are loving the conversation today. So happy that you're rejoining it as we celebrate World Earth Day. Today, we continue the conversation with Sam Bennett from Imagined Earth, a company taking recycling to the next level by rewarding customers for recycling with their innovative reverse vending machines. Whoa. Look, it's not an ATM. You don't just go there and put in plastic and get money out. So don't think along those lines. But there are incentives, rewards. And for me, it speaks to, Sam, this ecosystem that you're creating. You can use this tool to activate little financial ecosystems, find out what communities are using, what the needs are. There is so much potential there. Let's make this real. Talk to me about the people that are actually utilizing these vending machines. What does a customer, if you will, look like to you guys?
So it depends where the machine is, right? So we have your standard vending machine sizes, and then we have big containers. So the big containers we will then put into larger communities, normally lower LSM communities, because we can take higher volume. And there, the dynamic is completely different. The drive is completely
different.
It's
entrepreneurial. It's a business.
Absolutely.
Yeah?
And so this is the key, is to link waste management to social development and social upliftment. You don't need a degree to sort waste.
Yeah.
But you earn money immediately. And big brands have a responsibility and an opportunity to come on board. And they have, in many instances, to drive campaigns as part of this process. So
Maybe paint me a picture of that, because I like to play in this world of practical. How exactly can we do that? How can we further create more impact? Because it seems like there's a great ecosystem here, but nothing in an ecosystem works without input, without obviously keeping that sustained. How do you see that best playing out? What would make that amplify itself even more?
So it's happening at the moment when we talk about legislation driving things. So the extended producer responsibility is something that has driven brands to be responsible. Part of that is a mechanism called deposit return schemes. You probably won't remember, but when we were younger, you had refillables, right?
Yeah.
And so that whole concept of being able to have refillables is also part of this extended producer responsibility legislation. And DRS is rewarding you. It's a deposit return scheme. We have it right now with quart beers, 1.5 litre Coke bottles.
For sure.
Where you go in, you pay a little deposit, but you get that back when you bring it back. So we're keeping materials in circulation. DRS is driving that. So that is the key. It happens all over the world. But it has to be legislated, because everybody has to play the same game.
For sure. Well, there needs a baseline, because the companies that you're wanting, especially big business, they're not in the business of waste management. So don't expect them to suddenly be conscientized to go and do that. I absolutely get that. What's the end game here? What needs to happen? Because clearly this feels like the right path, and you guys have gone all in, as I've said on that. Where could we take this?
I mean, it's got huge potential. We were newcomers. We were first movers. We came in with an incentivized system before the legislation caught up. And we are seeing a phenomenal, phenomenal uptake of what we're trying to do here. From a community perspective, from a brand perspective, and from a legislative perspective. The more machines we can get out into the community, the more brands that we can get on board to run campaigns. I'll give you an example. We did a campaign with Adidas when they were doing Run for the Oceans. Mm. We all know that they make parlies out of material collected from the
beach. Recycled plastic, yeah.
So they ran a campaign, they put a certain amount of money into the campaign, and they said for every, I think it was 20 1-litre bottles you recycled, you got a discount off a future purchase of 250 Rand.
Mm-hmm.
Now you are changing the dynamic. It's not about waste management. It's about a retailer being able to have
a
future
tool.
it cross-cuts all sorts of different industries, but we're doing a good job. We're doing good.
Yeah, completely. No, I love it, because we get so used to this kind of CSR and CSI whitewash at the end of something just to get your tax break.
Exactly.
This is a real advantage there, and you get the added bonus of fitting in with the legislation as
absolutely
it moves in the right way.
Very powerful.
You're awesome, man. I know you said you can't get a degree in waste management or you don't need one, but you can get one.
You can.
And I'm thinking maybe, just maybe, this is what my passion is, man.
Yeah,
I love it.
This is something I think is absolutely empowering. I love the fact that the numbers mean we just win more, so let's get this out there.
Mzansi. Let's spread the word on this one and keep education rife. And while we're educating on some incredible causes, let's keep the theme going, right? Obviously, it's World Earth Day. And there's produce that you think should be something that we don't use anymore. And that's the ones that are wrapped in lots of plastic packaging. And we wanted to know from you to come through and add some more of these products to the list. What sort of packages of products would you like to not see anymore in the shops? I want to see it raw without the plastic. What do you have, Mzansi?
All right, so let's have a little look there. Who is that?
Obeidla Sali.
Obeidla. There we go. Morning, guys. Yes, everything that is covered with plastic and a ban on plastic bags at the shops.
Yeah, that should be like the norm. I think Gary Orkambos has something similar to say. He says it's impossible to get rid of plastic. The chemistry in the production of it should be changed so it can be biodegradable. I like that. I don't buy plastic carrier bags at supermarkets, but everything you buy and put into your eco carrier bag is packaged in plastic. Shocking face. And I think we all share that face as well. Why do they make it so hard for you? Like, can I go to the shop and actually take my thing out of the plastic and put it in
your glass?
I wonder if that's an option, actually. It should be. We should be not forced to take it.
If there was one, Sam, I'm going to put it to you quickly. One plastic that you could give the boot. What do you think that is?
I think it's important to understand that plastic is not all bad. A good example is the cucumber.
Okay. Right?
So a lot of people are like, why is the cucumber in plastic? Because it preserves its life for an extra 2 weeks on shelf. The environmental impact of biodegrading organic waste is significant from a methane perspective.
Oh, sure.
So we've got to just keep some perspective. Those dreadful bags that you get when you go to Woolies or wherever and you've bought your reusable bag and then you've got some cosmetics or you've got some cleaning products
and
they've
got
those barrier bags. Those are completely unnecessary. Those should go.
I'm going to say wipes. Wipes, wipes, wipes. Baby wipes. Any wipe should not be made with plastic. But I love this conversation.
Yes.
Share your thoughts with us. You can drop us a voice note 063-408-8863. That's the line to use if you want to chat about anything today.
Yeah, and speaking of anything, we've got anything and everything coming at you, Mzansi. We've still got something to dive into right now because she has been absolutely blowing everybody away. Our ears, our eyes, the TV screens have been going crazy, and she's still so young. So it's time to catch her once again. This is Can't Catch Me Now by Olivia Rodrigo, and this is, of course, Chrissy J. DeBeer coming at you once again.
Hi, guys, it's me again. But now I'm going to perform my cover from Olivia Rodrigo's song, Can't Catch Me Now, from The Hunger Games. And no, I haven't watched it, but I hope you enjoy.
There's blood on the side of the mountain. There's writing all over the wall. Shadows of us are still dancing. Falling over the city, you thought that it would wash away the bitter taste of my fury and all of the misses you made. Yeah, you thought that you'd got away, but I'm in the trees, I'm in the breeze, my footsteps on the ground. You see turning a new shade of red. Sometimes the fire
Absolutely beautiful. Oh, it's not very often that we are left like spellbound and jaws dropped. We just wanted another verse, please. Yeah. Oh, Chrissy ain't going nowhere. I love the confidence. The self-belief is just mind-blowing. You're a superstar, girl. Thank you so much for that.
You definitely are a superstar. Wow, with that energy, we're going to need to do something with it. So let's dive into the kitchen, make something spectacular. We're talking about casseroles and this beautiful
soul right here.
Perfect combination. She's back. Don't go anywhere, Mzansi. We'll see you after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. With a commitment to propelling innovation, enabling financial inclusion, and acknowledging excellence, EBSA Help Us welcome you back. And they recently held their inaugural commercial payment summit, and it was big.
It was a shindig indeed. This was an exclusive event. It was brought together by the brightest minds in the biz to give us a sneak peek into the future of payment technology and trends. Now, the one and only Harmony Kadalundi was on the scene to take all the notes. Let's find out.
As the payment landscape continues to evolve and innovate, recent data indicates that consumers are increasingly shopping online and embracing new payment methods. That's why I'm here at the inaugural EBSA Commercial Payment Summit, where the biggest names in the business are sharing the hottest trends and also being awarded for their breakthrough innovations.
Vish, how are you doing?
Yeah, great, thanks. And thanks for having us, Harmony.
Thank you.
As the market leader, EBSA is in a great place to be able to recognize the trends and the patterns happening on the ground. Can you tell us about how the buying behavior of the consumer has shifted?
What we've seen is people are becoming more convenient and more comfortable with using online payments and what we call in the industry card not present, so in a virtual environment. We're definitely seeing a shift towards that. We've seen as much growth at 25% year on year in the digital adoption. With hyperinflation, the consumer is finding real challenges. So we're noticing smaller basket of goods, but higher velocity of payments. There's a good fraction of high value, about 60% migrating to card or digital, but that's in value. In terms of volume, you still see a dominant player of cash. I definitely see a shift, but to your answer, I don't really see a world where everything 100% will move into the digital environment.
Imran, how are you doing?
Great, thanks, yourself.
I'm good. Can you tell me in what ways is Visa collaborating with banks such as Absa in order to promote innovative technologies within the payment space?
I think collaboration to deliver technology is one component, but there's very important objective we'd like to achieve whilst delivering technology. One is social impact. So we need to make a difference in what we're doing, why we're doing it, and you know, to who we're doing it. And the second is financial inclusion. And I guess it kind of doubles on the to whom we're doing. It's about expanding within our commercial space to offer business benefits and products and services to people to drive their business, to allow them to grow to its full potential. Working with Absa allows us to connect with their underlying clients, to get connect with the industry and with the market with an event like today, to create the awareness around the products and services and how we can partner with Absa to deliver to a market, create awareness on social impact and financial inclusion and how we can drive it in South Africa and across Africa.
It must be said that they are digital first, and that is what they will always look for.
Today was all about entrepreneurs, was about fintechs and about how we can collaborate in the payment space. So we're giving them that opportunity. It was all about inclusivity as well. These are young fintechs that are up and coming. Tonight is about celebrating them, showcasing what they've been doing.
If you look at where we are right now in terms of technology and you look at where we were years ago, you can tell that we're taking the right direction. Of course, without having to disclose quite a lot of initiatives, for example, the work the bank is working on, but you can just appreciate the idea that we're not just thinking about stuff. You know, people are thinking things and they're putting the efforts to make sure those things come to reality.
50,000 rand.
Firstly, congratulations on being one of the winners for tonight. How does it feel to be recognized for your work?
It's such a blessing to be recognized by one of the most progressive banks in South Africa, which is Absa. I'm just grateful for the opportunity. I'm just out of words. I don't know what to say, honestly speaking.
Can you tell us a little bit more about yourself and the work that you do?
I'm a primary agriculture student at Maluti TVET College. I'm also the co-founder of an organization called Know Your Rights, Alex Child. We do constitutional rights literacy to young children in Alexandra. My interests are in agriculture and civil rights. And now I think more of my interest and my knowledge is going to be heavily invested into the digital payment system because of Absa.
At the end of the day, the consumer, you and me, we go to banks. We are the ones that need to benefit from this collaboration. And business today is seeing that. They're saying, okay, we've got to work better collectively to service our customers. And if you look at pretty much everybody that spoke today was on a mission of, we're no longer telling our customers what to do, we're listening to what they need.
Industry trends, payment innovations, epic collaborations, and the youth doing the most. We are here to watch this beautiful story unfold. Hats off to the Absa team for paving the way and for telling us and showing us that your story matters.
Oh, thank you, Harmony. Hats off indeed, not just individuals here in South Africa, but small businesses, technology drivers in this critical space. Your story matters as well. We absolutely love that. Congratulations to all the big winners on the night.
There are stories of creators and
we're inspired by them all. We invite you to write your story with us. Your story matters. ABSA.
Yes, Mzanzi, and as promised, we are finally in the kitchen and doing something special. Yeah, winter, which is slowly starting to creep in, means that it's time to whip out winter warmers, and that's the stuff that's going to bring us all the comfort and flavor that we crave. I know you know what I'm talking about. So today we are making a delicious buttery pumpkin casserole that is absolutely fantastic, and it's a side for your weekly roast. So get involved in this one. It's something that's also going to add some great color to your Sunday Seven Colors menu, and the beautiful one and only Nondo Miso Peniate is here to show us how it is done. And oh, have I missed you, Melanie? How have you been? Can I get a hug, please, officially?
I know.
How have you been?
I'm glad. I've been great. I got my sleep. I got my rest. Then I'm happy to be back to share my love for plants.
Oh, I'm so grateful for that. You're looking incredible. You're still radiating the glow that I remember from way back then. It's actually a little bit brighter.
The flattery.
Well, come through, because with your bright soul and energy, that means we're getting a bright, colorful meal, and that's getting me excited. What are we putting together here? It sounds delicious.
This buttery casserole.
Yum.
So if you can please put the butter on the stove for me. We've already got
butter's
the stove
already on. All right, let's put the stove on.
The stove is on.
The stove
is on.
Okay, that is on.
All right.
Let me leave it to the professionals.
Okay. And then if you can help me by mixing all of these ingredients in here. So where that's for our seed crunch. We've got the egg yolk there. In the meantime, I'm going to be preparing our butter, our pumpkin.
Can I just run through the ingredients here just to make sure we're on the same page? And Zanzi that loves to follow. We've got sunflower seeds,
sunflower
seeds. What is this?
Some cashew nuts.
Ooh, okay, so that's just broken on cashew nuts.
You can never go wrong with cashews,
right? Yeah, and then some interesting spices.
Yeah, some cayenne pepper and some garam masala.
Are you sure we're putting this in here?
Yes.
This is crazy, all right. All that goes in there. This is going to be an interesting combination. And I'll mix this up while you get onto your side. What's happening there?
Yeah, so I'm going to be preparing our butter, our pumpkin. So I've got some honey here. Love the combination of honey and pumpkin. Hey,
oh, honey
so
with anything.
But when you, honey with anything.
Yeah, but
right?
When you're adding a pumpkin, it's like the negativity and all the guilt is just no longer there, because it's like health and indulgence combined. Come on.
Yes. So we toss that all together to make sure that our pumpkin is nice and evenly coated, and then we transfer it into our baking bowl.
Very nice little casserole dish. Can I just be honest and say that I genuinely doubted you when you put these ingredients in front of me? I was like, how can you mix sunflower, garam masala? But whoa.
Look how beautiful it looks.
Oh, it smells so good. Never mind the look, it smells so good. Yes, I know we are so caught up in the looks right now with veg and color and our seven color meals, but gosh, the smell of this.
I know.
This is incredible. It's got this warmth to it. It's something that I think is going to be perfect for winter. Well played.
Yeah. So I've got my knobs of butter on my pumpkin. And
knobs
this is
of butter. I love that.
It's a nice word, isn't it? Going to go into the oven for us to bake for about 15 to 20 minutes.
What and sort of temperature are we looking at there?
180 degrees.
Okay,
preheated oven. And if you could just transfer this into the baking pan for me.
Right. So this goes at, like, is this the base of the pan?
Yes, so it's already been greased and everything.
Uh-huh.
We transfer that, and that's also going to go into the oven for about 15 minutes, also at 180 degrees. And we want to bake it until it's nice and crunchy. Okay.
So is it going to end up like crunchy, hard, almost to the point where you could pick it up maybe? No?
Yes, so actually we don't want it to necessarily be to form one solid piece.
One clump,
it mustn't be one clump. So we want to be able to spread it around our final dish.
All right. Now, we're getting ahead of myself, because I wanted to talk about the butter, but you're already busy with the butter over there, which is smelling so good and making a lot of these meals and these recipes that much easier. I mean, besides just using fresh pumpkin, right, the star of this dish, like I mentioned now, is definitely Clover's Moy River butter. Clover's Moy River butter is a salted butter. It's perfect for cooking, for baking, and of course spreading. And as you can see how easy it is to make any meal right now, we're doing exactly that. But we just love how it makes like the flavor come through in a dish. So don't be shy when adding it to your dish. You can add lots of buttons, like Nondo Miso mentioned now, and it's definitely going to bring out and highlight the incredible flavor that we already have in this dish. So the perfect combination.
Yeah.
Love it.
And when you assemble your dish, so you wanna have the butter, you wanna add the pumpkin, and then you wanna drizzle some of this nice, beautiful golden brown butter that we got here. Okay, so you want to leave it on the stove for about 5 to 7 minutes to get it nice and golden.
Is this what it ends up like?
Yeah.
It's like Mother Nature's nectar.
I know.
This is so good. It smells
amazing.
Absolutely delicious. Yum. Kryptonite.
I know, butter is also my weakness. And of course, when we want to sprinkle some or just lay out some of that cheese, so we are going to be using, what cheese are we using today? I don't know why.
It looks like we've got some feta over there on top of that one, yeah?
So we're using feta and, of course, laid out with some basil.
Nice. Okay. All right, so I was, like, coming here being very nervous, thinking that you're going to make this so complicated, but that was so easy,
yeah.
So simple. I think anybody can replicate this, even myself. And I've been paying a lot of attention. I hope you have too, Mzansi. Go over to expressosocial.com. Get this incredible recipe. Don't forget your dollops of butter because it's going to make it that much good. And I think you can start building your winter menu. This is going to be superb. Well
yeah.
done. Thank you for coming through. Can we please see more of you? This better not be the last.
I hope not.
Okay. I believe we have another recipe later, so I'm already excited for this one. Mzansi, you can be too. Don't go anywhere. We're going to fill up those bellies with some more good stuff. Nicely done.
Hey, thanks.
Yum.
Indulge in Clover's Moy River Pure Salted Butter. Perfect for cooking, baking, and spreading. Elevate every dish with Clover Moy River Butter.
Don't fall victim to intestinal worms. Use kid-friendly Vermox twice a year. And get rid of unwanted guests. Vermox.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back. I think all of us have felt the change in the season. Generally, it's when our skin starts to dry up and crack. We all need a little bit of extra moisture as we head into the winter months. So we thought this would be a great opportunity for us to do a little bit of prep and invite one of our favorites in here to give us a bit of motivation and maybe a play-by-play on how we can look after this most valuable organ that we have all around us, our skin. And we only get one skin, so we really do need to look after it. Dr. Lauren Knight, a dermatologist who has been an incredible resource, is here right now. And I think a lot of us right now are reaching for something to moisturize a little bit more. And of course, this conversation coming courtesy of CeraVe. And we're going to hopefully be able to help a lot of people because this is one of those universal things. And for me, generally, it happens when I fly from Cape Town to Joburg and then I feel it like 100 times over. But maybe let's look at some of the heavy hitters, things like eczema, those that flare up specifically around this time, and then management becomes critical. It's not just a nice to have. This is something, especially if it's your kids, it becomes very real.
Yeah. So I think the winter wreaks havoc on all of our skin. We start feeling, like you say, as that temperature drops, the humidity saps, and especially, like you say, on the higher level lying areas of our country.
Oh, you feel it,
so yeah. We're all subject to this barrier impairment. And if you've already got an intrinsic barrier impairment from your eczema, rosacea, you're going to be doubly hit. So you really, really want to be thinking about moisturizing and how you're going to preserve that skin barrier and really, really look after your skin to limit those debilitating effects of the change in weather.
And it can, especially when you see it playing out for a young person. But equally so, if you've lived with eczema or a skin condition like you've mentioned for most of your life, it kind of becomes a baseline experience of life. You've always got to think about that first. Mm. The routine is a good thing, though, if you can get it right. So what sort of routine should we, when you talk about protecting the barrier, that seems to be the key battlefield here. How do we get that right?
Exactly. So, I mean, not all routines are made equal, so you don't want to be spending a lot of time doing the wrong thing. And I think it really starts with regulating your environment. So you want to make sure that you're protecting your skin. You know, in these cold climates, you want to make sure you're limiting your exposure of your skin to the elements. Then you're going to think right from when you're doing a bath time. So right from your gentle cleansers, soaps that don't strip your natural lipids within the skin. as soon as you get out the bath, you know, resist that urge while you're in the bath to turn up the heat really high, because that also just damages and splits your oils within your skin. Wow. So you're wanting more of a humid or a little warmish bath. Get out.
Can you repeat that for my wife, who literally, if I've got to hop into a bath after, I get cooked.
We all do. You're just longing for that warmth.
That comfort,
you know, resist the urge. Keep it nice and lukewarm. Warm the room, rather. Get out, pat down the skin. I think that's the thing. Resist the kind of rubbing of your skin. Pat down your skin. And it's actually ideal to apply your moisturizer onto dampened skin, because you've already got that little bit of a layer of moisture to lock in. And then remember, you really want to look for a moisturizer where you can cheat a little bit or actually optimize the function. So you're wanting something that's fragrance-free, that has nice emollient properties, so that's going to really moisturize the skin. Wanting something that's going to lock in your intrinsic moisture. And then you think about ingredients or moisturizers that have extras, so your boosters. Do they have ceramides? Do they have glycerine? Do they have humectants in? Do they have hyaluronic acid in? Do they have urea in? So extra boosters. So you're already putting a moisturizer on, but can you be doing something extra with your moisturizer?
It's like a sheet of armor.
Exactly.
I love it.
And
you need to start thinking about that, because the accumulative damage, if you don't get this right, you know, you start to feel it at my age, you can start to see those gateways that you might have missed. And going retrospectively, often we can't deal with it. You've mentioned some heavy hitters there. What can we do? Yes, we've got our daily routine, but when we are experiencing dry to the point of flakiness, when things are really flaring up, what are those products that really do help us? And you've mentioned a couple already. Yeah,
so I think really just a non-fragrance, gentle moisturizer, a wash, suited to your skin type. So you don't want to be damaging your barrier from the outset. And then look for moisturizers that do have actual active ingredients that help to restore our barrier. So if you think of our skin, we speak of a brick and mortar model, where your skin cells are little are the bricks, so your keratinites are the bricks, and your in-between cement or mortar is your ceramides, your cholesterol, and your natural moisturizing factor. So what can you do to actually repair that? So look for those active ingredients. So your heavy hitters in the skin barrier are really gonna be your ceramides, your glycerine, your humectants, your urea, hyaluronic acid. So those are ingredients that you really should be looking for to try and control that flakiness. The other thing is to look at what you're doing. So are you using a lot of active ingredients that potentially are okay in summer? So your retinoids, your alpha hydroxy acids, that when you step into the cooler winter months where your skin is naturally drier, you're gonna be exacerbating that flakiness by continuing to use these at a higher frequency. So you might need to step back a bit. But we do realize that you do want to potentially still exfoliate somewhat to limit that dullness, that dryness, remove some of the flakiness.
To refresh the skin, yeah.
Yeah, and then you can look and change to rather using your polyhydroxy acids, which are going to be exfoliating but also moisturizing to the skin.
I love that. I love the fact that you can get a one-stop shop. These days, there are some unbelievably good products. The most important factor is you being consistent and doing it and applying. Don't leave it too long. It's one of those things that I think, maybe because it affects so many of us every day, that you might overlook it. Don't sit with dry skin this winter. Be proactive now. I know it's still a bit hot in some parts of the country, but it's going to get real very quickly. You have at hand everything you need to find that perfect balance for you as we shift gears moving into winter. Doc, thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Again, absolutely appreciative of these conversations. Thank you so much, Doc. But for now, though, it's about to go in the hour, and it's one last round of official duties. Now, starting with national headlines, issues affecting children on the African continent will be in the spotlight, and this during a three-day African Children's Summit to be hosted in Johannesburg in August this year. Now, some 500 children are expected to attend the event, both physically and virtually. Now, the 2024 African Children's Summit is endorsed by the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child. Now, the summit aims to address all social challenges facing children, with children deliberating on how this should be achieved. Now, the inaugural Africa Children's Summit was held in Nairobi, Kenya, in April last year. While sticking to national headlines, Fly Safair yesterday confirmed that one of its flights, FA212, all the way from Johannesburg to Cape Town, was required to return to Johannesburg after its wheel was damaged during takeoff. Now, the airline said the aircraft left OR Tambo International Airport on schedule at 11:32 a.m., but after takeoff, ground staff at OR Tambo reported witnessing what appeared to be damage to one of the aircraft's back wheels. Now, the crew were alerted to the observation, and the decision was taken to return to Johannesburg.
Now, this being said by Fly Safair spokesperson Kirby Gordon. Well, we now move over to international headlines, and all U.S. soldiers are set to leave Niger, and this ending their role in the fight against Islamist insurgents. Now, military leaders in the West African nation have sought closer ties with Russia since seizing power in a coup last year. Now, during the past weekend, the U.S. also announced it is to close its drone base in the Sahara Desert. Now, Niger is in Africa's Sahel region, which is considered the new global epicenter of the Islamic State group. Now, the U.S. has in the past always monitored regional jihadist activities from Niger. Well, next up in the headlines, President Volodymyr Zelensky has expressed his gratitude. Now, this to the U.S. House of Representatives for approving a new $61 billion package for military assistance to Ukraine after months of delays. Now, he said the aid could save thousands of lives, and the much-delayed measure had vocal opponents in Congress, and it took a fragile bipartisan to deal, and that was to pass a $61 billion package. Now, Republicans said more than a third would be dedicated to replenishing weapons and ammunition, and this would most likely include air defense systems, mid- to long-range missiles, and artillery shells. Well, finally, this morning we can categorically state that South Africa remains the most affluent country on the African continent. Now, this as a report published by Henley & Partners in partnership with the New World Health has confirmed Johannesburg's status as Africa's wealthiest city, and that with Cape Town closely following in second place. Now, moreover, SA cities and regions dominate the top 10 rankings, with the Cape Winelands at 6th, Durban and surrounding areas at 7th, the Garden Route at 8th and Pretoria at 10th. Now, Cairo, Nairobi and Lagos also featured prominently in the rankings, making up the 3rd, 4th and 5th spots. Now, this latest report truly highlights SA's significant presence in Africa's wealth landscape. I'm absolutely here for this and celebrating all the rest of the headlines. And here's the latest in sport one last time with the G-Man.
Thank you so much. Well, let's start with the high-stakes cup action over the weekend. It was Bernardo Silva's late goal that propelled Manchester City into the FA Cup final yet again, with a 1-0 victory over Chelsea, who've proven themselves to be cup specialists in the staple, and despite a challenging match, Silva's decisive strike secured the holders' win. And then in the other thrilling semi-final, Manchester United, they edged past Coventry City, or punching way above their weight class, and they had to do it on penalties after a dramatic 3-3 draw in extra time. But United's perseverance paid off as Rasmus Højlund's penalty sealed their spot in the final against their old foes, Manchester City. We love it. Now let's turn to rugby, and not a great weekend from our perspective. In the latest round of the URC, the Lions shone brightest. Well, they shone alone, actually, with a dominant 44-12 bonus point victory over log leaders Leinster. Can we just say, Robbie Gillette, you called it, son. Well done. And they secured the sole triumph for South African franchises. So disappointment loomed as the Sharks fell 21-10 to the Glasgow Warriors. Then uncharacteristically, the Bulls suffered a 27-22 defeat at the hands of Munster, looking very strong at the stage of the season. And then the Stormers were defeated 27-21 by the Ospreys, who found another gear here in Cape Town, undoubtedly. So what does this mean? Well, the Bulls dropped to fourth place. The Stormers, they slipped down to sixth. However, the Lions, they keep themselves in contention for a quarterfinal spot, while the Sharks, they hold on to 13th place. Now let's turn to tennis. And speaking of resilience, world number 6, Casper Ruud, he clinched victory at the Barcelona Open, defeating his old foe, Stefanos Tsitsipas, 7-5, 6-3, in a commanding performance. So the win marked a sweet revenge for Ruud after his loss to Tsitsipas in the Monte Carlo Masters just a week ago. The Norwegian, with 11 career titles, including this Barcelona Open, secured probably the biggest trophy of his career. So despite 3 previous final losses, Ruud's perseverance paying off with his first title of the year, and I think solidifying his position as a force to be reckoned with on the tour right now. Now, he's a force that no one can reckon with at the moment. As we turn to motorsport, Max Verstappen, he capped off another commanding weekend by clinching victory at the first Chinese Grand Prix in 5 years, further solidifying his lead in the World Championship. So after a dominant sprint victory, the 3-time world champion, he controlled the race at the Shanghai International Circuit. That looked great. He finished 13.7 seconds ahead of Lando Norris, and then Sergio Perez making up the rest of the podium. And Verstappen's near-perfect weekend was only marred by the disruptor. Fernando Alonso still doing what he does, his late dash for the fastest lap. But otherwise, an absolute brilliant performance for Red Bull. Now with his fourth Grand Prix win this season, Verstappen continuing to assert his dominance on the track. He's going to be difficult to chase down pretty soon. But that's where we leave our sport for this Monday morning. Let's get one last look at the roads before we let you go to work.
Thank you so much, Jim. And yes, one last time, let's see how we can serve you when it comes to the roads. And let's move to Centurion in Johannesburg. Now, there are roadworks taking place on the N1 southbound, and this after the Flying Saucer interchange. Now, as you can see, two lanes are closed. Delays are expected. So please, if passing through the area, plan accordingly. From Johannesburg, we move to Cape Town and Langa, to be specific. Langa, there has been a bus accident in Langa on the N2 inbound before Bunga Avenue, and the right lane is closed, causing heavy delays. Now, please do allow for more added travel time, and again, plan accordingly if passing through this area. From our roads, we head to the sky one last time to find out all about the world of weather. Diving into the world of weather one last time, and the SA Weather Service has cautioned residents across five provinces about the heightened risk of wildfires due to extremely high danger conditions. Now, these conditions are particularly concerning in various areas, and these include parts of the Free State, the central regions of the Northern Cape, the southern areas of the Northwest, the western areas of KwaZulu-Natal, and the northwestern parts of the Eastern Cape. Now, residents are advised to exercise extreme caution and adhere to fire safety protocols, and this to prevent the outbreak and spread of wildfires during this period of heightened risk. Now, on top of this, we will once again dive into our favorite part of the morning one last time. This is our sunrise view of the hour, and it was sent in by Nancy all the way from Pennington in KZN. And yo, this is drama, this is action, this is an absolutely incredible moment captured by you, Nancy. Thank you for this. The ocean, the sunrise, all the magic that we came for. And I think you can officially call yourself a winner for this morning. Thank you so much, Mzanzi. The number once again to do it all again in the morning and share these incredible sunrise views is 063-408-8863, where we get to do it all again. For now, though, one last round of temperatures to see what you can expect on your side of town.
Way up there, so don't go out just yet. Rather stay indoors and contemplate your winning numbers, because your Monday could end with a big bang when you play Daily Lotto for an estimated 430,000 rand in the jackpot, and it could be yours. It could be your big payday today, but you got to play.
Yeah, you got to play and get involved in today, right? Now, luckily, there are so many ways to buy your tickets, and I'm going to plug you in on just how, right?
Okay.
So you can go into the store, you can head over to nationallottery.co.za mm-hmm. website, or you can use the mobile app, and mm-hmm. you can also purchase a ticket through your cell phone banking. Mm-hmm. All you got to do is dial *120*7529# and then follow the USSDs. Simple as that.
Five ways.
Options, yeah.
You got options, man. You don't need to use them all. Just do one, or if it's your lucky thing, then you can use them all. We don't care. Just put yourself in line. All those details will be kept up on the Expresso social media platform, so you can go and check them out at your leisure and literally have no excuse not to win big. Will the 430,000 rand in estimated daily lotto jackpots be heading to you? Well, you've got to play now to find out. Good luck.
Hey, now, what we will find out right now before you even play that game is the next of what we get to look forward to in your Feel Good Breakfast Show. We've got someone that graduated, by the way, Craig Lucas. I don't know if you know the superstar, the singer, the songwriter, the everything. The man's graduated?
What? I know.
Insane. Look at him. Look at it. Oh, come on. Cum laude, I'm not sure. I don't know what it was, but we're going to find out more about that. I'm so, so proud of this man.
Yeah, amazing. Man. And helping us get through that and all the rest of our entertainment news, I think we can just call her the TikTok girl or the girl from TikTok, pretty
the
much.
The one and only.
Navaan Ferris is here. She's doing incredible things. If you're a content creator who wants to know how to do it well, do it properly and absolutely nail it every time, she is your plugin. Stick around for that.
There are stories of dreamers, and we're inspired by them all. We invite you to write your story with us. Your story matters. ABSA.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. Oh, yes, Mzazi, welcome back. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and let's call this the show of inspiration.
Yeah.
Because we're all about empowering our youth today, and it is your Monday Feel Good Show. So let's keep that inspiration going right now, because joining us is Navaan Ferris. I'm sure you've heard this name before. She's a digital content creator, but most people might know her as the girl from TikTok. So let's give her a Feel Good welcome.
Pew, 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 pew.
It is her! It's the girl from TikTok! How are you doing?
I'm good, thanks, and you?
Good.
Does that happen? Because you've been around, been doing this, you're kind of one of the front runners from a South African perspective to get this kind of, this balance right, to crack the code, so to speak. Do people stop you and talk about your content, and do you get this kind of reaction now?
All
you've...
the time.
I love that for you.
Yes.
I think in the beginning it was very nerve-wracking because I'm an introvert, so I'm like, how do you know me? But then I'm like, okay, I'm on TikTok now, but now it's I'm actually known as the girl from TikTok. Some people can't say my name. So when they see me, like, The girl from TikTok. I'm like, yeah, I'm one of them. But I get that a lot.
I'm one of them, yes.
I got to ask for you being an introvert and having to kind of like expose a lot of your vulnerabilities online. Yeah. Mm. That's very intimidating, let's be honest, in a game where you need to be getting exposure and you want to be gaining more attention, right? Well, what's that feeling like? It's quite a tricky road to transition into.
I do panic
sometimes. Okay, so you are human. That's good.
Thanks for opening that up for us.
Yeah, it's more of a thing of you kind of force yourself, as an introvert, I force myself to come outside of the box because it's required of me.
Yeah.
And a lot of people are like, how are you an introvert if you here on TikTok doing all these things? Yeah. I'm like, it's just me and my phone. Yeah. That's literally all it is.
It's a safe place.
Yeah. But I think I've kind of gotten used to being an extrovert when need be. And it works out for me. People actually like it when I talk a lot. and I'm not to myself.
Look how she's
We love it, I know. Look, it's like you keep discovering the superpower every day. You're like, wow, I can actually just open up and people love it. They just love me being me.
I can communicate with other people.
And you can communicate to a lot of people. TikTok has been a game changer. I'm the first to put my hand up to say I was very judgmental. Oh, it's dancing.
Oh, yeah, same.
It is changing lives, albeit we can't dance. So that might have been the barrier that stood between us getting there. But you don't have to use it for dance. You use it to connect one-on-one with people.
Yes, definitely.
And that's a very powerful thing where you kind of, the responsibility is being authentically you and being yourself.
Yes.
Why TikTok? What is it about this platform that you think works so well?
It works well for me personally because TikTok is generally curated around dancing. And I love dancing. I was the child that they put at the family gathering and say, show them what movie you made last night. Yes, so I think it worked well for me because as an introvert, you don't speak a lot. On TikTok, you don't need to speak a lot. You just go there, do the TikTok challenges, dance,
just
whatever.
Yeah.
And then it was what I liked and it just worked out for me because of the whole dancing thing.
Everyone likes it now.
Everyone loves it and everybody is inspired by it. But I'm more inspired by, though, is how you do the extrovert things. What are you doing behind the scenes when you're not extroverting, when you're not doing your thing and creating content? Where can one find you? Are you, how are you empowering and fueling the soul? Working out, maybe?
Yeah, no, yes.
Oh, yeah, yes.
I got the gains.
Oh, okay.
But generally, I'm always with friends, working out. Or with my dog. I recently got a dog.
Congratulations.
A Yorkie.
Oh, cute. Yeah.
Or you can find me Netflixing and chilling, just like relaxing.
Okay.
Because in this social media thing, you need to relax sometimes.
So we can be human and still be a content creator. You don't have to try and like disguise yourself from the real world and then one thing. I like this. There's a sense of normality. And I think that's why people resonate with you, because you're real.
Yeah. Like you must see both sides. It's not just... and then going on TV shows.
Yeah, completely.
Like sometimes I'm also a couch potato and I just lay there and watch TV or go do normal people things.
Well, I suppose being professionally yourself, you've kind of got to, because that can always be on and you've got to learn to be able to switch that off. You've also got a lot of passions. We see like with kids are obviously something that you care very deeply about. You now have an active, very captive audience.
Yeah.
What do you want to achieve with this? Is your notion of what you want to do with your platform starting to evolve the bigger you get?
I think my main objective with all after seeing how much people watch me or how many people watch me, I think my main objective was always with the kids because, like I said, I have a passion for kids, but for me it was just teaching people how to be authentic. Like you can be a nerd or an introvert or a shy person, but you can still, it's okay. Like you don't have to do all these things for people to like you, and that's something I struggled with. So I think for me that's very important and that's what I base my platforms around. And my social media accounts just to show people, be authentic.
And be happy.
I was going to ask you for some like words of advice and inspiration, but that's all the inspiration I need. I couldn't be any truer to it. And I'm really grateful that you are able to find this space where you can be yourself and express, because I think it's what a lot of us need right now.
Yeah.
We need people that we can see in spaces like this that are still having the sense of normality, showing us how they juggle these spaces, but at the same time, you're still doing it right with a sense of like passion and happiness, which is very very important. I like
Definitely.
That.
No filter required. Yeah. No filter required. Well, maybe sometimes a filter on the mouth, but not on the face, girl. It is the girl from TikTok. Nivan, you're absolutely amazing at what you do. Please stick around. We want to have a little bit more fun with you if we can.
Definitely.
Now, speaking of having fun on the show, okay, when there are deals on your favorite appliances, those must-have, those things you've been lusting after, that's the best time to make that purchase. Uh-huh. Catch some incredible deals, something really special this Thursday. That's the 25th of April, 2024, this week on Espresso, of course, brought to you by Samsung. Then you know it's going to be crazy, man.
Oh, man, it's going to be crazy, especially the fact that they're celebrating 18 years as the global number one TV. So you know it's going to be a powerhouse day. Mm. I can't wait to see the options. I can't wait to see how happy customers are going to be when they get these opportunities, because let me tell you, Mzansi, it's going to be good. It's going to be absolutely incredible, and especially seeing that these appliances have such great longevity. They're so important for our household and important that we make these purchases and get those things that we want.
Well, they're investment pieces, and generally with a Samsung TV, you don't need to replace it. You want to, because your old one's still fine. Okay, and
but
it's probably still big enough.
The new ones are so much better.
Yeah, there is something about the queue that comes before the LED that's just amazing. But the bottom line is we're going to do something very Samsung, and you know when it comes to Samsung, those giveaways, those competitions, those deals are insane. And this Thursday, it's going to blow your mind. Just imagine playing live on the show to buy that thing with the button. I mean, come on, it's going to get crazy. So don't forget to catch Espresso this Thursday for a very good Samsung deal for your home.
Oh, yep. Now, look, we've got a lot to look forward to still. Mzansi, Nivan's not going anywhere, because we're going to dive into the world of entertainment and find out what Skinner and T she's going to be sharing with us. I hope you get to enjoy all of this in a little bit. Laat ons net 'n bietjie gesels right after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back. Time to have a little bit of fun. Time to get a little bit of the spice introduced here. And, of course, we've got Nivan in our studio to help us dish all of the dirt. We're going to be talking about entertainment now, getting into some entertainment news and catching up with some of our favourite celebrities. And, yes, earlier we mentioned Craig Lucas getting a degree. We cannot wait to delve into that. But so much has been happening across the world, dude.
Yeah, let's dive into this first conversation. Performing artists and business mogul Rihanna, who has young sons, right? Now, she's doing something incredible. Boys, and she's also got rapper and boyfriend ASAP Rocky, and they were asked in a recent interview whose show she'd like to jump in on for a day, and she answered by saying the children, and admitted because they live the greatest life and she would be delighted to experience that. I absolutely love that sentiment, and I'm pretty sure they do live some incredible lives. Can you picture what these kids must be doing
now? I will take their life any day. Any day.
I love it. Your dad's one of the most famous rappers. You're named after two of the most famous rappers in the world. Gosh. And you're hanging around with Rihanna's mates all day. But she does seem like the most fun kind of mom, because she's still, it doesn't look like she's sold out at any point.
Yeah, I mean, it's Rihanna at the end of the day.
Really?
And I think with that being said also, it's not just like the Rihanna that we probably know, but it's the real version of her that she's actually giving to her kids. I'm so, so confident of that. And that's also another reason why I think this is going to be an incredible sort of story to follow as we see these kids grow up. It's going to be a new generation of people that are going to be, I think, well-balanced to say the least.
Yeah, now they're going to rock and roll with parents like that. They're going to absolutely nail it. Now, speaking of powerhouse parents, okay, let's go back in time a little bit. This is a bit of a weird one for me. R&B singer Ashanti and performing artist Nelly, of course, rekindled their love and got back together in 2023 after a full decade apart. You probably won't remember this. You might be a little bit too young for this one, but Ashanti recently revealed that they're engaged and expecting their first baby together.
That's insane.
I love R&B Nelly. I've always loved Nelly, so I'm really happy.
I know, and these are two, like, absolutely incredible artists from back in the day, so it's so cool to see how, like, paths can reconnect, and it ain't over till it's over, and clearly this one ain't over at all. I love
it. Very sweet. All right, this is the big one.
This
because
is huge.
We love this kid. Do you know Craig Lucas? You must have met him in the space. Okay? Just one of the sweetest human beings on the planet. Well, he recently celebrated his graduation with a master's degree in development studies at the University of the Western Cape and said that he wants to pursue a PhD as soon as possible. And he continued to say that he feels like he made family and this is not the last that they will see of him at UWC.
That's huge. I mean, juggling as much as you do in a space like this and then still getting a degree on top of it. I don't know, Yvonne, if you ever have any goals of wanting to study or if you have even started it, but it's not an easy thing, right?
No.
Especially in this day and age. I mean, how much time do you even spend on content creation? Can you think that you could find other time in the day to study as well?
You can, but it's very difficult because, I mean, university requires so much of your attention. So now you kind of have to juggle, okay, what's more important? Content creation, which is your job, basically. Or papers and studying and exams and all those things.
Which is also maybe like a future job. So how do you juggle all of this?
I must do this, but I must also juggle this job to get that job.
I can literally see the arithmetic like going on in your brain right now.
All the math sums, it's just, okay, what now?
But he did it, man. So Craig, we are so proud of you, buddy. We are so proud, just like your family and everyone else around you. We are so, so proud in light of the last year that you've had. To find this kind of motivation and resilience, we love you, kid. Well
done. Talk about inspiration. But listen, let's dive into this next conversation, something that I'm still celebrating. I'm celebrating this one, and I want you to understand why we should too, right? So media personality Boiti Tulo, obviously dabbled in the world of business. She always is involved in so many incredible things. Now, she launched several business ventures over the past few years, but in recent news, her perfume that she launched in 2020 was being sold at huge markdowns, and this is something that hit the blogs and got a lot of people talking. But Boiti stepped forward and admitted that the business failed. It was very disappointing. Life happened. But we try again and keep moving forward. And that is what I think is important.
Oh, completely. Because, look, every other business that she runs is incredibly successful. So let's just kind of say she's got a kind of different baseline to the rest of us. But, you know, CR7's fragrance also bombed.
You know what I'm saying? True.
Like, don't think that a fragrance, it speaks to what she is doing with her platform. And I'm here for that. When you see a South African hitting those levels of success in the industry, that's got to get you pumped.
South Africans are doing a lot lately. We're going places, I must say.
You think we could possibly see a sense of Nirvana coming through in the future?
Listen, I'm not going to say anything, but I'm just saying watch out.
Watch this space. And when we talk about having a captive market, she is having a captive market. Now, maybe you are a content creator looking for your big market and your big opportunity. Well, Tropika Island of Treasure is, of course, heading to Zanzibar that we know, along with the hostess with the mostest, Zanele Potelwa. She's going to be running the show. And the bottom line is you could be pairing up on the Tropika Island of Treasure with one of these celebs, Chad Jones, Omutle Gela, Ngobile Kwezi, Carl Kugelman, Hungani and Glovu, and Davi Nokeri, and hashtag beat Bobby, Bobby Fun, Yasbelt.
Yo, it has gotten so crazy out here that we had to quench ourselves before we carried on this. So cheers, guys, to that.
Please.
So really exciting news, but it doesn't stop the Mzansi because we still have so much to talk to you about, because all you need to do is simply upload your audition video telling the Tropica team why you should go to the island to social media, and of course using the hashtag Tropica, and go to My Tropica and let us know, right? So you can also email your answer to tropicaauditions@gmail.com, or you can upload your answer to the link found on the My Tropica pages. That's like three different ways to get involved. You can do all of them actually and increase your chances if you want to.
And you know there are people doing that.
People are doing that, man.
People are hungry for this. So with the process so smooth, you've really got nothing that will hopefully stand in your way than your own confidence. So we want you to just do it. And with just under 2 weeks left to audition, we thought we would show everyone at home who hasn't auditioned how it's done, okay? And we've also got one of the coolest content creators here to maybe give us some advice. So from our space, we want to mention your name. Obviously, you want to introduce yourself and confidently. You want to highlight your strengths. You want to highlight your weaknesses so that your partner can balance those out. But the honesty in saying that, I think, is a massive tick in the right box. So this being said, if someone's going to send in a video introducing themselves to they've got to speak to brand, because it's obviously Tropica. Mm-hmm. They've got to speak to the show's dynamic, which is challenges, mental, physical, and craziness. But it's also TV land. They must be entertaining.
Yeah.
What is your advice for someone looking to make their mark in an audition video?
Be authentic. Be authentically yourself. I mean, when you are authentic, that should actually be my brand.
Okay,
authentic.
Authentic, I love it.
I think you should just, the main thing with an industry like this is no one can be you. So if you're going to audition by being you, that makes you stand out already. Hey, look at me.
Look at you.
Giving speeches.
No, 100%. You're absolutely right.
Yeah. So for me, I would just be me and be like, you want this on your show. Trust me. You must be convincing that, this is who they need and what they want.
Believe it yourself, like man. I love that, because everyone else is going to be trying to copy who they think was popular and hot on Insta or on TikTok and try and give a version of themselves. If you can nail just being you, that really is your superpower.
Already winning. Yeah, already winning. Now, listen, it's not just one that we're looking for. There are seven lucky contestants that will be chosen to head to the Tropical Island of Treasure. And already, just by being a contestant, you'll receive 10,000 rand before even getting to Zanzibar. And that's courtesy of Deep Heat. So thank you so much for coming through on that one. So all you got to do is enter, right? So remember, competition and auditions close on the 5th of May. So you need to get entering. And for a chance to win that share of 1 million rand, you want to get involved in the T's and C's, which do apply. And of course, everything right here is nothing else other than smooth.
It's $1 million, yo. Come on.
We're in Zanzibar for Tropica Island of Treasure. Are you? Did you just swim here from South Africa? There's an easier way to find fame and your share of a smooth million rand fortune. Simply upload your audition to social media, explain why you're a match for our celebs. Add the hashtag Tropica and tag @MyTropica, and we could see you in Zanzibar. Buy a Tropica now and enter to be on the island. Oh, you can make
my day. Drained? Dehydrated? You have lost more than just fluid. Recover faster. Add Rehydrate, SA's number one oral electrolyte mixture.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Now let's have the conversation properly. Let's go deep right now, because I don't think a lot of us like to think about the long term. When we think of our retirement, we picture the beautiful beach house, the fancy sports car, the epic world travels, and all the time we'll have to spend with our families. But have you taken the necessary steps to manifest that, to begin saving for that life that you really so badly wish to live? Well, if a slight bit of panic is kicking in right now, don't worry, because it's shared by all of us. It's never too late. And joining us this morning to guide us on our financial journey towards a stress-free retirement is a very seasoned financial planner from one of our favorites, Alex Forbes. Please welcome Butle Nkomalo. Butle, welcome back. I love the fact that you and your team enjoy talking about the things that most of us are terrified to do, because it just gives us a hand to hold. So why? Let's start with that. The why it is so important to think about our retirement, not tomorrow, but today.
So retirement is also very important, because basically what it is your younger self preparing a savings and an investment type of thing, where you know that once you retire, that you can retire comfortably. Are you able to, you know, sustain a certain lifestyle that you might require? So all the living that you're making while you're employed, you need to try by all means to save as much as you can, so that you can have a much more healthier and fulfilling retirement.
What does that look like? How does that journey begin?
The rule of thumb is that you should at least replace about 75% of your income that you had while you were employed. So you can just imagine, if you need to replace 75% of your income, of course we're not saying contribute 75% of your income towards your retirement, but it's a slow process. So whatever you put in is not necessarily just that you're going to get out. So if you employ the correct investment vehicles, you employ the correct investment strategies, you look at what your risk profile is, and you put it into, put your investments into assets that will really make a good return for you, give you some good savings for you in the end, then you know that you're going to come out with much more than what you had actually put in. So it is a long game.
And for someone like me, I don't have the financial acumen to look at the long game. I'm not blessed with that. I'm an in the moment, this is where my world plays out. So you need the right person to balance you out. And I need to go to my consultant with a few things bedded down, i.e., how do we know when that line in the sand needs to be drawn?
So that's where your financial planner comes in, right? And your trusted financial planner.
Exactly.
So what we're great at doing is that we take you, like you said, we hold your hand and we walk you through this journey. We don't just now start sitting down with you when you're 2 years away from retirement. We start sitting down with you and we start looking at your year and year. You should have at least a review of your retirement savings.
For sure, yeah.
To have a look at, are you still in the right track? Are there any changes that need to be made? You know, and then that will give you an idea as to, okay, now I am actually starting to get ready. And if you're not, then we can make some adjustments. What are the adjustments that we need to make? And you don't just need to think about what your income is. There's a myriad of things that you need
to think about.
You know, what expenses, what are your expenses? What are your
medical? What do you actually need?
Absolutely. What are your needs or your wants? Look at your budget, try and scale back on whatever expenses that there might be. And there's so much that you need to think about heading into retirement.
So it helps having a playbook. And you guys have written the playbook, literally. So I understand that you are the perfect person to start and continue that journey with. But as we are speaking here, you're not in the business of money, you're in the business of people. Every person is completely different. There might be trends driving the industry, and there might be new advancements in terms of how pensions are put together and how that plays out, but ultimately, people are people. What other advice do you have? What other things should we be thinking about when we think about our retirement?
I love what you said there, that, you know, we are not just in the business of money. We're in the business of financial wellness.
For sure.
We're in the business of time well spent. And what other things you need to think about is your medical costs, your legacy. Do you want to leave a legacy behind for your family? Do you have a spouse that will be needing an income, you know, should you pass on before them? Do you have children that you want to leave something behind for? Also, as a financial planner, we look into things like your estate planning. So we'll do look into your will for you, make sure that your finances are taken care of. As you get to your retirement age, this can be either the age of 60, 65, you then either decide to defer your retirement, what we call deferring your retirement. And what that is that you are retiring from your employer. However, you're keeping your retirement savings invested within the fund.
Why
you would decide to do this is because it gives you a bit more time to build up on your retirement savings if you feel like you need to do some catching up. You've got what we call the option of either going into a guaranteed annuity pension or going into a living annuity pension option. So at the guaranteed annuity pension, what happens there is that your income is guaranteed for life. So what that does for you is that it takes away the investment risk in your retirement income. So your retirement income is guaranteed for life. You never have to worry or stress about your money running out. And then when it comes to the living annuity option, that's a bit more flexible in the sense that you get to choose your retirement rate of income. And this is every year on your anniversary date, you'd get together with your financial planner, review your investment, how has it done over the year, and then you can then choose to change your income, either increase it or decrease
it. To bolster it up.
Absolutely. So obviously the more income you take, that's where now the risk of a living annuity comes in, because now you face the risk of outliving your pension.
For sure.
So like I alluded to earlier, you need to think about what your life expectancy is, how long do you expect to live, and make sure that your retirement savings are able to take you that extra mile.
I love the fact that you guys are just so authentically who you are, and you love what you do, clearly, because of the effect that you have in people's lives. Mm-hmm. So thank you for helping us play the long game. For me, it's the emotion that comes with the advice that you offer is quite a special balance to have. So thank you so much for representing that. So whether you are saving for retirement, maybe looking even further forward, your child's education, maybe wanting to even pay off debt that is still yoking you from the COVID days, take that first step. Reach out to the experts at Alex Forbes so that you can have a guide, someone to hold your hand through this journey. And consultations are absolutely free and can be scheduled, well, today. Hopefully there's an opening at alexforbes.com. Just reach out. And on a very exciting note, just adding to that, we are giving you guys the chance to win 5,000 Rand to put towards your goals. To enter, tell us what your biggest investment goal for this year is. What are you saving for? Share your answer with us on our Expresso Facebook, Instagram, or X platforms using the hashtag AlexForbes. And you can find the T's and C's on expressoshow.com. All the best of luck. Thank you to you and your amazing team. Thank you for doing what you do every day.
Thank you so much.
Well, from great conversations, it's time for a Game Store's Igruza. That means more bang for your buck recipe. Get ready for it. Yes, bring on the Igruza. It's time for one of these delicious meals where we're making a mouth-watering sweet potato and beetroot salad with creamy honey dressing. And let's talk savings, right? We got pickled beetroot, honey and vinegar, which are pantry champions that can jazz up any dish without breaking the bank. And the beautiful Nondumiso shows us exactly how it's done.
Yes.
Right, ready for round two with some more delicious meals?
Yes.
Let's bring it on. How are we doing this one?
All of these vegetables, are so I'm overwhelmed by all this beauty. Okay, so I'm going to start preparing our sweet potato here. I love that we're using the Kara sweet potatoes, which is the orange sweet potato.
Uh-huh.
Very, very thick and creamy, so than the average sweet potato.
I like them when you use them for like chippy things because of that exact reason.
Right.
It does have that sort of creamy center, which is like so synonymous with like a good chip, but the health box is being ticked on another level here. So a great alternative here, I think, as well. Eh?
Yes, yes, yes. So I'm adding some olive oil, some thyme.
Okay.
For that nutty flavor. And then, of course, some salt and pepper. Now, can you please help me put together the dressing?
The dressing, yes. How are we doing this?
Okay, so you can add one tablespoon of that vinegar.
Okay, a tablespoon of vinegar going in. Just grab that tablespoon there.
Okay.
All right.
And
what's
then
next?
The yogurt, which is this one.
This is about a cup, right?
Yes, you can just add all of that.
Some of that goes in there. Okay.
And then, of course, we've got some mayo there, some delicious mayo.
Ooh, this is going to be a creamy one. This is going to be
very
good.
Creamy. Very good for winter, hey?
Yes.
Yeah.
Good fats coming through there. All right, it looks like we've got some mustard. Yes,
mm-hmm,
that's correct. Excuse me for questioning, but you know, I always have my doubts when it comes to identifying these. And you don't always have a professional like you in the kitchen, so it's always a pleasure. Just got to make sure.
Yeah.
All right, that's parsley, right? And then some salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper.
We'll pop that in there. Bah, bah, bah.
And then we're going to add some honey as well.
So you right. How much honey are we popping into this one?
Just two tablespoons, yeah?
Little drizzle.
Yeah, just drizzle some honey. And I'm going to pop this in the oven, and we're going to bake it for about 20 minutes.
20 minutes? What's the temperature on that? Again, 180 for safety?
180 preheated oven. We mix it all up until it's well combined.
Ooh,
So it's a very simple, straightforward dish, right? But also very healthy and nutrient-dense.
That's what I was going to say now. With all the, like, sort of ingredient nutrition that's coming in here, it is nutrient-dense. It's so simple to make. The sort of aromas coming out of this thing, the tanginess is on another level. And let me tell you, Mzansi, we've got, like, a pickled beetroot, which obviously adds tanginess and colour without the hassle of boiling fresh beets, right? But honey is also something we're using here, which is not only something that sweetens our dressing, but also acts as a natural preservative, which means it extends the salad's shelf life. So with that being said, we're going to come through and serve you. We've got a deal for you right now. You can get this, right? 780 grams of Koo beetroot, and that's 2 for 60 rand. That's a 2 for 60 rand deal. It's absolutely incredible. And on top of this, it doesn't stop there, right? We've got another one, 500 grams. It's the Little Bee Honey Squeeze, right? That's the honey. It's a 2 for 120 rand. That's the one that I'm using right now on our screens. It works so well in this dressing, and you can't even notice the fact that we've put honey in here, apart from the incredible taste. So definitely get on this one. And then, like you've just seen now, we use some vinegar. So we've got a 750ml Safari vinegar, and you can get any 3 for 70 rand. This is huge. Do you want to step up your pantry staple stock right now and get these essentials that definitely aren't going to break the bank? And it's valid until the 30th of April in store and online. So hurry up, get involved in this one. And if you want to get your hands on this mouth-watering recipe as well, then you can simply visit expressoshow.com. It really was that simple. Are we done with this? No, not yet.
We're not assembling it very quickly.
Okay, so this has come out of the oven, right? You had that 180. It's looking
amazing.
Nice and crisp, yeah.
Yeah, we're going to add our rocket there. Love to add some rocket. And of course, can you bring me that feta?
Yeah.
We're adding feta again, but you know what? Beets go really well with goat cheese. If you're feeling bougie,
beetroot
and goat's cheese is a real combo.
Delicious.
But of course, this is more accessible. So definitely add some of that feta, and then we top it off with our beet.
Pickled beets that we just spoke about right now. No, Misa, that was absolutely simple, easy, but providing us with so many boxes being ticked when it comes to health, nutrition. I think that there are so many people out now salivating over this that we need to share this with the people, right? We've got Nivana. I saw she was eyeing this earlier. She said to me that when she's not creating content, she's out in the gym. So I thought, why not give you an incredible meal that will serve that exact purpose? Nivana, does this look enticing to you?
Oh, it looks very nice.
I can see that smile on your face.
With your eyes first.
Yes.
Would you do us the honors of giving us a taste test? Would you mind?
Do you trust my opinion?
I do. Okay. As long as it's honest, I want your opinion right now. Let's bring it on. We are diving into this easily. Oh, I need to grab a... here we go. Let me just actually dish this up for you, because we have a lovely one that's been prepared already. And I'm going to do the honors. I'm going to ask Nondabisa to just grab one of those forks out on the drawer on the right-hand side while she does that. Let me get some of the good stuff, salad and everything else. And again, Mzansi, reminder, you can head over to expressoshow.com for this incredible recipe. VIP service for the queen of content creation, the girl from TikTok, Nivan. The proof is in the pudding. Them, Mzansi, this is where we really got to make sure that you get a good answer.
The pressure's on, girl.
You don't have to speak with your mouth full, but you can even just give us a yay or a nay.
Mm.
Is it a yay?
I say yay.
She went for seconds, she's going for thirds. I think it's a yay. And if you saw high five, Yvonne approves it, of course,
for you,
Mzansi. You can take that with you while I plug you in on something incredible. You obviously stand a chance to win a 2,000 Rand Game Stores voucher, and that's a shopping voucher that you can use to buy some of these incredible deals and so much more. Simply reply to the competition post on the Expresso social pages and tell us, what is the one item on your wish list that you'd check with the Game Stores price beat promise? Now, don't forget to use the hashtag GodGame, and the competition closes on Tuesday, the 30th of April at midnight. Now, your T's and C's do apply, so head over to the expressoshow.com website for more. And a reminder, the store opening hours are Monday to Friday from 9 to 6, Saturday from 9 to 5, and Sunday and public holidays from 9 to 4. And clearly, it was good. Yay, nay?
I want to take another bite.
Okay, you can have all of that just for you. Thank you so much for coming through once again, for sharing in our, showcase of some of the inspiration that we have, and that means you too. So hope you enjoyed that, and hope it's fitting of our content creation queen of the day.
Oh, yes, definitely. Yes. I approve.
She approves, yes! SpecialShow.com. You got it. Nice.
That is actually very good.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Back, Mzansi. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and what an incredible show we have had this morning, showcasing some of the most incredible talents, especially when it comes to the young superstars. And speaking of, we got.
Oh, man, she has blown us away by her nature, her personality, just how ready she was to embrace this opportunity. And it speaks to a much bigger picture. She is going to shine, and she's only just gotten started. Here to perform her brand new song called Pieces of Me, and If Anything's Left by Jamie Fine as well. It's the incredible and very young Chrissy J. De Beer. The stage is yours. Take it away, girl.
Hi, it's me again, and I'm going to perform my song, Pieces of Me, my new latest single, and please download it on all major platforms. Hope you enjoy.
Keep going, won't ever see the bad showing. No, you won't get.
My next song is going to be a cover from Jamie Foxx's song, If Anything's Left. And I heard that she might be in South Africa. I hope you enjoy it.
It's Moy River Pure Salted Butter. Perfect for cooking, baking and spreading. Elevate every dish with Clover Moy River Butter.
Another feel-good production.